What you're about to listen to is part of the Podgods Network. If you go to podgodsnetwork.com, you'll find other great shows there too. If you have a problem with this or any other show, please write it in an email. And go fuck yourself. Have a nice day!
All right, you primitive screwheads, listen up!
But more of the R-rated film that most other people do. There's some salty language in it and shit like that.
We work very well together, okay?
But it's gruesome twosome!
Gruesome twosome!
Pardon my French, but you're an asshole!
These guys are 11.
I'm here for the gangbang.
I have come here to chew bubblegum and kick ass.
Inconceivable!
And I'm all out of bubblegum.
Oh, no, not the beast!
Ah! I feel like I'm taking crazy pills!
What? Say what again? I dare you! I double dare you, motherfucker! Say what one more goddamn time!
They've done studies, you know. 60% of the time, it works every time.
That doesn't make sense.
Set no substitutes.
Hey everybody, this is Salty Language, episode 158. I am Brian, making my triumphant return to the podcast. Joining me from the Camp David of Shameless Plug Studios is Tony.
We need a creepier name or something for his place.
You're right.
I like Camp David, but it's too
Can we call
political.
It like Crystal Lake or something?
Camp Crystal Lake?
No, just Crystal Lake. Wasn't it?
Oh.
Or was it camp from Friday the 13th?
I thought it was Camp Crystal Lake.
I don't remember. Eh.
Hmm. Eh. Know.
It's all
exactly.
That.
Exactly.
Yeah. I guess I could find out while we're just yammering.
Yeah, that involves stuff.
Right. So do I call this temporary Shameless Plug Studios, or should I just, you know, or does where I'm broadcasting from need a new location?
I would still call it Shameless Plug Studio.
Because it's either that or I'm just going with parts unknown.
Peeved a little.
What was that?
Oh, shit. A little Skypage, huh?
Yep.
I would still call it Shameless Plug Studios.
Okay. We'll go with that.
So it's just been upheaved a tad.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Because it's, I mean, there's nothing better than plugging shamelessly.
Yeah, you're right. It is Camp Crystal Lake.
Perfect.
So there you go. Not to be confused with Camp Crystal Light, which is, you know,
awful,
which is a whole different thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The lake's all like raspberry, whatever the fuck.
It's like raspberry margarita or something.
Yeah. Man. Some awful tea, quote unquote, flavor.
Right. Right. Ugh. All it tastes like is aspartame.
God, I love those cancer crystals.
Yeah. Yeah.
Delicioso.
Right. So for those who don't know, I wasn't on the show last week because of moving, which was all sorts of fun. I mean, just, I can't even describe how much fun it was.
Please try to.
No.
Okay, fine.
Well, I pretty much moved about 30 bags of trash off of my porch.
Yeah, what'd you call it? Mountain garbage,
yeah,
right?
Yeah. That was a lot of fun.
Did you leave, like, a six-pack and a smile for the garbage men?
Nope.
Or fuck them?
Nothing.
Nothing. Poor fellas.
They didn't take stuff that wasn't bagged, though. We had to pay a few bucks to have them come remove that.
Ah,
but,
right.
And whatever. It's done. Yeah. So I had to cram a, you know, a two-bedroom place with a lot of stuff in it into, you know, a storage spot and a room. Which, for those math experts out there, doesn't quite work.
Sure. I'm over here doing the arithmetic, Brian.
Yeah.
It's not working out real
It's
well.
A shame we don't have John on the show with us.
It's true.
He could help us out here.
Yeah, it's true. You helped me out on a math problem earlier on my Instagram that I screwed up.
You certainly did. The worst part is it wasn't very complicated either.
I know.
It was just, you could have even used your fingers.
I saw that message come through and I was like, God damn it.
Yeah. Well, at least if you're going to be corrected, it's by a math teacher, right?
That's very true. What the hell was that?
I don't know if that was me. Oh, you know what? I bet that was me because I forgot to close something.
I was just too excited by the potential Batman axe picture. So,
yeah, you'll do that.
Yeah. Eh.
Come on now.
These things happen, right?
Right. That's all right. I'm sure he'll forgive you or taunt you as he should.
Yeah, it's true. Well, I mean, in theory, this month he's coming back to our area to visit family and such. So,
yeah.
I'm sure, you know. It'll all be forgotten about by then.
Probably, yeah.
Yes.
Between all the drinking that all of us do, I'm sure it'll be forgotten.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah. So, speaking of drinking, I, you know, I, of course, listened to the podcast, you know, because I heard I was called out on said podcast. So, you know, I'm not one to respond without knowing what I'm responding to, you know.
That's fair.
Right. You know, I'd like to be educated before, you know, yelling at people, which I'm not going to yell at anybody because, you know, whatever. You know, if I had planned better, I would have went to Beer Fest. So, I mean, that's really what it comes down to.
I'm going to chalk it up to the shit happens category.
Yeah. And the thing is, given where the time was and how things ended up working out, I could have gone. We could have taken that day off, but the day after it rained a lot, and we didn't end up doing much the next day because, you know, you can't really move certain things in the rain easily. So.
Right.
But, eh, whatever.
I don't know what the hell that was.
I don't know. So I have a list of some things from the podcast, though, that I wanted to bring up because, you know, for those who didn't listen, shame on you, although I do understand because, you know, it was tough for me to listen to because I wasn't on it.
You'll have that.
Right. So, you know, I was sitting there going the whole time, and I'm like, you know what this podcast needs? More Brian. Same thing every podcast.
It's lacking a certain note.
Yes. Same thing every podcast needs. More of me.
Cheers.
Right. So, you know, you guys were talking about the, like, setting up of a camp.
Yeah.
On the podcast. And, you know, and Jeannie made the comment. She was like, what, are we too good to sit on the ground? I would like to answer that with yes. Yes, I am.
Probably bring chairs as well.
Absolutely. With my knee conditions, if I've been drinking and I hit the ground, I'm done. It's over, Johnny.
You know? I'll have to, you know, call an evac or something.
Right. If alcohol sweeps my leg, it's over.
Oh, man. I didn't know alcohol was on Cobra Kai's team.
Exactly.
That's a problem.
Especially if we're drinking in those amounts, it's probably not going to turn out well if I end up on the ground.
Fair enough. Yeah. I don't think it'll work out well for anybody, to be perfectly honest.
No. So there needs to be chairs of some sort. However, you have to be careful what kind of chairs because, you know, you have to make sure they're not ones that'll tip easily.
True.
Otherwise, whoops-a-daisy, and there could be spillage or a kilt flying over your head.
Awkward for everybody.
Right, right. So also I'm disappointed that, when you guys were talking about the video and how a lot of it turned into, you know, a montage of Jeannie's chest.
Yes.
How you did not point out that I called that because when you first talked about it, I was like, it's going to devolve into you just staring at Jeannie's chest.
Yeah, I think you're right. You did say that, didn't you?
Yep. So, which is fine, but you know, whatever. I'm just making sure I get my credit.
Credit due, right?
Right.
Yes.
I was disappointed you didn't push harder to workshop on the program, you know.
It is what I do.
Yeah.
It just felt wrong without Brian there, though.
Yeah, I understand.
You know?
I understand. Even if it is blasphemous, it's fine. It's all right. We'll let it go.
It's true. These things happen.
I really think that hashtag slightly intoxicated should be a thing.
I agree.
When you mentioned it, I was like, yes, that's absolutely something that should happen.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
It makes perfect sense, right?
Or we may have to come up with just a shorter tag, because that's a lot to type, but especially if you're slightly intoxicated.
Yeah. You know? Maybe like hashtag SLTX or something.
Yes.
No, ITX.
Yes, that'll work.
Or INTX. I keep adding to it.
You do. I don't.
I'm a jerk.
Yeah. I'm with your wife on the vuvuzelas. Nope.
But.
Nope.
What if I want to announce my beer?
No, probably a bad idea. Although it would be kind of funny for you to announce your beer.
Harold's trumpet made of brass and such.
Well, that's fine. Yeah.
All right. Here we go. Cat, of course.
Right.
Gone all day. Get out of here. No.
For those of you who've just started listening last week and this week, potentially, the cat is not a meowing sound bed that we have. It's.
You would think, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
It's Jesus.
Yeah. So, how is it that T said that there was no internet in various places up there? How is that, the savagery of that? How were people, were they just clubbing each other and knuckle dragging, or what was going on?
Well, once you throw enough delicious cold craft beer into your gullet, you don't even notice.
That's true. My phone does tend to stay in my pocket the more I drink. So.
Yeah, same here.
Okay, fair enough. I just had to ask the question.
Like we had our big maps of the whole, you know, all the beer lit checklist.
Right.
And we were just marking the ones we drank and then putting our untapped rating next to it. So the next day we could go back and put them in.
That makes sense.
You know?
Yeah. That makes
sense.
Because
we tried doing it the first year and it was not. Although Josh was doing it on the fly using Siri.
Oh. So
yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Makes sense. Make technology work for you.
Got it. He kept talking into his phone. Best IPA I've ever had.
All right, then. Yeah. It wasn't really going into Untappd or anything, though.
Yeah, it was just into the, you know, he's probably calling somebody.
Who is this?
Oh, I don't know, you.
Sir, are you going to order anything or not? Best IPA ever, man.
Best IPA ever.
Yeah, and then the one last thing I had to ask about the last show.
Yeah.
Was listening to that a room was really tiny and that T was sleeping on basically a garbage bag and a bale of hay. What the hell kind of place was that?
Dude, it was the Hampton Inn, which is all right.
Yeah.
And we're supposed to have a king-size bed, right?
Mm-hmm.
And we walked in, it was probably, was it a queen or a full? It was a full size.
That's not quite a can.
And then there was a roll off up against the wall with that was the and it was tied to the frame of garbage bags with no bedding.
Oh my god, that's amazing.
Yeah, that's what T's bed. And we're like, really? Because I thought we were supposed to have like two. No, we're supposed to have one. And we're going to trade with Josh and Rose because they had two. We never ended up doing that.
Right.
Eh. But yeah, it was bizarre.
So it's my fault that T had to sleep on the bag of whatnot.
Nah, you probably would have been spooning him or something. So,
no. Damn, now I'm sad I missed it. No,
I don't know. Yeah, actually, because we canceled the one room because we don't need two rooms now. You know?
T can just sleep at the foot of the bed.
Yeah, exactly. Put him on the trunk.
He's kicking in the middle of the
night. Well, I mean, to be fair, anyone who knows T, you know, you just give him somewhere to prop up and
that's
he's
true.
Out.
That's true.
You know?
Yeah. Not to mention, I can't feel too bad for him because of, you know, Bachelor Weekend with him,
yeah.
Like, taking a night of sleep away from me. So.
Yeah, exactly. When he, you know, he has a steel chainsaw on his neck.
Right. Fair enough. I was wondering because, like, listening to you guys describe this, I'm like, did you guys go to the murder hotel that I stayed at?
Yeah, it should have been a decent place. Well, the problem was we showed up before he could check in.
Uh-huh.
We're like, we know we can't get in the room, but we want to check in.
Right.
So we have a room. And the guy was he had no idea what was going on. So we ended up just throwing our hands in the air and leaving.
Right.
And then we probably got, you know, whatever room was still left over, basically, that they had reserved for us still, but we got some. it was a handicap room. So our bathroom was gigantic and.
Which is, yeah, that's fantastic.
You know, and I mean, right. You know, and if I was really, really hungover, I mean, the bathtub had like a bench in it, which would have been awesome.
Right.
But, yeah, it was shit.
You guys probably got the enthusiast suite.
Enthusiasts for shit.
No, it's where they put enthusiasts.
Oh, I see.
Like, oh, I see you're an enthusiast, calling you an asshole, of course.
Of course.
And then they're like, we have a special room for you.
Yes. Right this way.
Yeah, it says janitor on the outside. Son of a bitch. Yeah.
Well, right. We did decide, as much as I love T, that I cannot share a room with him because I just can't sleep.
Because of the snoring?
Oh, my God.
Well, you saw, show fixed that. You know, he propped his head up with a pillow. If you can do that, it made a huge difference between day one and day two.
I wasn't moving. I was scared.
Or put a pillow, or apply a pillow directly to his face.
Yes, angel of death style.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was just like, you know, I felt like hot garbage. It wasn't because of drinking. I mean, granted, drinking is probably part of it, but I just did not sleep.
Yeah.
Kept waking up, and yeah, I thought like the whole building was coming down. I'm like, oh, it's just tea over there.
Like, no, this is Fallujah. Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. I'm like, are we getting shelled? What's going on?
Yes.
Oh, my.
Yeah. Sounds like the Destructicons are, like, wrecking the building.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And, you know, part of you is like, because it's just loud as fuck.
Yeah.
But the other part is like, oh, my God, is he going to die in his sleep?
Well, it could be worse. I mean, it wasn't like, what's his name from the Bachelor weekend?
Oh, God. Shit!
I can't think of his name either.
I know. I'm drawing a complete blank on his nickname.
Big something, but I can't remember what it was.
Big Danish.
The Big Danish. There you go.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Where he was like gasping for air. At least he's not that bad.
I mean, I guess I could have pulled a sock and just started yelling at T.
Right?
Open your fucking throat!
It's called breathing! Yeah, that would have been amazing.
All the neighbors, because those are like paper-thin walls. Neighbors be like, what the fuck?
Especially when they see you guys coming out the next day or something.
As I'm yelling, open your throat!
Yeah.
Like, oh my, what was happening in that room?
Yeah.
Oh, do tell.
Go on. Yeah. So, all right. Well, yeah, that recaps my listening to the show.
All right.
So,
since we have Beer Fest going on here, though, Brian, Fall Beer Fest.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna buy you a ticket for your birthday.
Nice. I like these plans. Yeah. When is it again?
So you have to absolutely go. It's the end of October.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. I think this is
doable.
And
it's in Detroit.
Right.
Yeah. Should be awesome.
Yes.
So I'm just letting you know.
Right.
That you have a ticket coming your way.
I already have waterproof shoes also. So
I don't know if you're going to need it for there. Maybe for a bum piss, but I don't know.
Well, that's what I was actually thinking because I'm just going to let it go.
Oh, perfect. Yeah. What, is this frozen? Stop it.
Might be. Don't knock it until you see me in my Elsa dress.
That's true.
I look smashing.
Every time we go to one of these fests, we become more and more obsessed with going to more of the festivals.
Right. And you become more of an enthusiast.
Boy, do we. I made my first batch of beer today, finally.
See, what did I tell you?
Yeah. I've had a kit that Don bought me for like over a year.
Yeah, I was like, didn't you get that for a birthday?
Yes.
Okay.
Not my most recent one.
Okay. I couldn't remember if it was that one or the one before. All right.
Yeah.
You know, these things blur sometimes, especially when they're not mine.
You know, as much as we enjoy drinking beer, I'm like, I just really do. And I was talking to some guy at Beer Fest drunkenly in line about it. And it's like, all right, I just had to pull the trigger on it. And I made it today.
Nice. Busy Hands Brewery. Nice.
That's an excellent name. In fact, because it's going to be 2 months, because everything I read online about the Mr. Beer Kit is they're like, it's like training wheels. Severe. It's Fisher Price's My First Brewery. Right?
That needs to happen. New from Tony Co. Products. My First Brewery.
My First Brewery. But
turn your little tyke into an enthusiast.
That's awesome. The commercial's just like little drunken kids driving power wheels in the trees and stuff.
Right. This guy.
Oh, I just shit my pants, but I got a diaper, so we're good.
That's the best time to shit your pants.
But, no, I read online, though, that, you know, because I was, like, looking for Mr. Beer tips, some way I can, like, make it a little better.
Right.
And they say in instructions you let it ferment in a big-ass keg for, like, 2 weeks.
Uh-huh.
And then you put your bottle and let it ferment for 2 more weeks, and then enjoy! Everything I read online is, like, let it ferment for a month, and then do it for another month in the bottles, and then it's way better.
Uh-huh.
So that's what I'm going to try.
So it's going to be aged a bit.
Yeah, a little bit. And, you know, it's because it's a starter kit. It just comes with, like, American light lager.
Yeah.
Which is not really my thing.
Right.
But it starts somewhere, right?
Yeah, right.
Yeah. Although I think we might, I don't know, I think I might start piecing together legitimate home brewing stuff.
So then the next step is to get bourbon barrel casks, right?
Oh, that'd be awesome.
Right? I know Don will hear this and be like, yes.
Yeah, that would be phenomenal.
Or Shecky, for those who've been with us for a while.
That's quite the callback.
Mr. Falsetto, I believe it was, wasn't it? Shecky Falsetto?
Shecky Falsetto, joke man.
Yeah.
Wow, that's going way back, yeah, Brian.
I'm sure he'll dig that. Or was it Detective Shecky? From your video. I can't remember if he's the detective or a lieutenant or whatever he was.
Yeah. I can't remember. I think it was either detective or lieutenant. Lieutenant sounds more, Lieutenant Shecky Falsetto.
We'll promote.
Something like that.
We'll call him lieutenant, whatever.
Okay, perfect.
I don't want to call him
chief. If not, he got a promotion.
Right, exactly. Yeah, he deserves it. It's all right.
It's perfect.
Yeah, he's an all right guy. We'll go ahead and promote him.
Yes.
So, yeah, that's... I like that.
And they just said that the Winter Beer Fest is going to be a two-day event now. That's pretty awesome.
Oh, I didn't know it wasn't.
It was only a one day, yeah.
So are we going one day or 2 days?
I don't know. We haven't really decided about the winter.
Fair enough.
Fall's only one day.
I'm just asking,
Yeah, because winter is the one in Grand Rapids. And I said we need to do 2 days because then we could definitely get with Jason.
No.
Over the course of 2 days?
No.
It has to happen.
Nope.
Drop in on Monkey Poo Studios, do a little recording.
I like it. He'll probably just think we're his kids.
Probably right.
Yeah. We'll just make sure we wear, Batman shirts and stuff, and he'll be like, when did I get more kids?
When did this happen?
Actually, why didn't I just move into Jason's house?
You never would have known.
Damn it.
And you would be in the best beer city in Michigan.
I know, right?
Yeah, it'd be perfect.
Damn it. And there would have been all the podcasting stuff there. I wouldn't have had to do any work. Damn it, man.
See? We still got time.
All right. All right, I'll put it on the to-do list.
Excellent.
All right, so with all that out of the way, what have you been up to since BA Fest?
Work, Brian.
Setting an enormous fire earlier. I saw that.
That was awesome, though.
For those who follow Tony on the Instagrams.
Yeah, well, I've been throwing my stuff across Twitter and Facebook now, too. Well, because I'm back on the up. On my cycle of in Twitter again.
All right. You know? I forgot. That's right. Yeah.
Yeah.
Right. So Tony, master of multimedia, has been posted a picture of a Christmas tree going ablaze today.
Yeah, I've been waiting to throw it in the fire, and like I was telling you, we had some extra kids in the house, so I'm like, hey guys, come see something cool.
I've been waiting to throw that in the fire, and we had some extra kids in the house. If you just stop right there.
Oh, yeah, that's
much
true.
Funnier. Like, you're just winging kids in there for kindling or something.
Perfect. Yeah. Y'all are witches.
Yeah. Get it? Kindling? Ugh. There's a bottom shelfer for you.
It's been a while.
Yeah. Well, when I come correct,
It's the old bush light of puns.
Definitely. Watered down.
Watered down.
From the mountains of Denver.
Do you know what today is, Brian?
No.
Today is, I don't know how many years it's been, about 3 years since we started the podcast?
Yes.
Today is the exact day we did our first podcast.
Oh, is it?
However many years ago, because I put it in my phone.
It's three, yeah.
Yeah, so I put it in my phone as birth of the podcast.
Nice. I knew we were getting close because, with episode 156, that's three calendar years of shows.
Right.
One a week. So I knew we were getting pretty close to the actual date.
Yeah, today is the date.
That's what I like to hear. Yeah.
Boom.
And like I said, we, one every week. We haven't missed a week.
Damn straight.
So,
Things get a little hairy, we still make put one up there.
That's right.
Somehow.
Yeah. I know. Last week was a little scary. I thought we were going to miss one, and I'm like, man, we can't come right off of 156 in a row, go, oh, look, we have three calendar years of podcasts. And then go, all right, we're going to skip the next one.
Although it would be kind of funny.
Well, I mean, even Cal Ripken at one point was like, all right, I'm not going to play today.
Yeah.
So.
Hey, it happens occasionally.
No.
Not with us, though.
Nope.
Iron Man.
I am right.
And stuff.
Yep. Man, 3
Although,
years of this.
I got to say, way easier when there was a third mic to lean on.
Oh, show. You are correct,
like,
sir.
I'm not going to be there. No problem. We got
this. No worries.
This.
Yeah, we got this. Yeah. I mean, we had a couple of times where it got a little squirrely to where, you know, we had some scheduling, this and that, even with the three, but, you know.
Yeah.
But, yeah, most of it was was pretty good.
Yeah.
That's all right. This way there's more room for my ego. So.
Boom.
Yeah, because, yeah, I needed it. No.
No?
Not really.
Not so much?
Whatever.
So, you know the Destiny beta, right?
Yes, the one I didn't get to play because it conveniently ran right across the 2 weeks of my moving.
Yes. Mm-hmm. I didn't realize I had such a short time limit on it.
Yeah, I didn't either.
Because they put a thing up that was like, hey, Destiny beta for gold. I'm like, all right, I'm in. So I downloaded it, and I played through the part where you learn how to play the game.
Yeah.
Which was pretty boring.
I didn't even get to play that.
It looks sweet.
Yeah.
And then it's like, you're in this big city, and it's like, here's where all the Guardians reside. Mm-hmm. I'm like, save, I'll play again later. Went to fire it up, and the beta was over.
Yep, yep.
God damn it.
Yeah, it ran for a week, I believe. Like, the first week was, I think, Xbox One and PS4. The second week, I think, was PS3 and Xbox 360.
Now, this is coming from knowing zero about the game besides the Bungie game, and
right.
You know, I've always been a Halo guy. So.
Right. From what I understand, from what I've read and stuff, it looks a whole bunch like it's, and Garrett mentioned this too, is it reads and looks like it's basically Borderlands set in Halo.
That's what it kind of feels like to me.
Yeah, it's got the customization of Borderlands, yeah. But it's set in like a lot of the characters that have a Halo-ish look to them.
Yeah, they look very Halo-ish.
Makes sense.
Yeah, there's different classes, and you can level them up with different tree systems.
Right, which is very Borderlands, yeah.
Yeah. It seems like, and I wish I got a chance to play it, because I assume it's an online shooter.
Yeah.
And if that's the case, and you're, like, fighting other people, it could be a lot of fun.
Right. But, you know, what stinks is that there's the beta, and it doesn't come out till September. I mean, I know it's only a month, but it just seems like forever away.
God.
Yeah, I pre-ordered it a while ago, because the reason I pre-ordered it was so I could get into the beta, and then as it went on, they were basically just like, beta for everyone, pretty much. And I was like, well, okay. I mean, I was probably going to buy it either way, but, you know.
But I spent, like, a whole evening down, because it was, like, almost 6 gigs to download.
Yeah, yeah. Like,
and
I got
to play it for, like, 15 minutes.
I was in the alpha also.
God damn it.
And got to play it, didn't get to play it because of the way things worked out. The alpha was only open for, like, 5 days or something. And
right.
Then they shut it down. I was like, damn it. And then the beta came up, and I was like, all right, I had it all downloaded.
Well,
and
maybe there's going to be a Destiny Charlie or something.
Probably not. I got a feeling I'm probably Whiskey Tango Foxtrotted out of this one. So
nice. Whiskey Tango Foxtrot.
Yeah. Wah, wah. Sad trombone here. Oh, well.
Yeah, you'll have that.
I haven't even hooked up my game systems yet. Since
what?
I actually, for the 360, I'm going to have to buy one of the wireless dealies.
Oh, really? Oh, yeah.
Because I'm too far away from the router that I'd have to have like a million miles of Ethernet cable to hook it up.
Yeah, fair enough.
Which stinks because, yeah.
I just say, we got to get you online. It's, you know, I've been still GTAing it like crazy.
Mm-hmm.
And this weekend's double experience points, basically.
Oh, is it? Well, I'll have to see. Maybe I can finagle something. Because I think Sho has the wireless deal. Maybe I can just borrow it from him until I can get one or something. Boy, yeah. So, yeah.
Oh, man.
Yep.
Although some jerk-off wrote, I was playing earlier today.
Well, I bet you were.
And this is one thing I did not enjoy about the online experience. Was I spawn, right, after doing a couple missions?
Yes.
And with the new system they put in, I know it's going to bore a lot of people, but go fuck yourselves. With the system they put in, like, if people are going bananas in the game, their dots are red because they have a mental state.
Right.
So I spawned close to...
Bananas.
Yes. Exactly.
Sorry, I couldn't help myself.
So I spawned close to this guy, but because I've been playing all these missions, I've been shooting all my guns and shit off.
Right.
I'm, like, out of ammo.
Well, hold on. Now, like, what? Shooting your guns off, like... A redneck on the 4th of July or shooting them at people?
At people.
Okay.
Because they have one of the games you can play is Survival, and it's kind of like Gears of War Horde, when you just got to survive wave after wave.
Destiny's Child playing in the background.
Yeah, it's awesome.
All right.
But
would be if I was playing. Sing it, Beyonce.
Right. So I basically only had like pistol ammo.
Yeah,
and I'm guy this guy, and I just honestly, spawn.
Pistols suck a bag of dicks in that game.
Yeah, and I don't have good ones yet.
Yeah,
because I haven't bought the good ones.
Yeah, that's all I have probably is just a pistol and probably.
If you haven't really played, yeah.
Yeah, I probably have that and a rock I can throw at someone.
Yeah, awesome.
Yeah.
But so I spawn guy by this guy, and he immediately just guns. And he's a red dot. He just guns me down.
Yeah.
And I'm like, all right. So I respawn, and when you respawn within the same circle where you died.
Of course. Yeah.
So this guy just kept killing me over and over and over again.
Oh, yeah.
And it's like, really, dude? And I couldn't do anything because I didn't have any ammo.
You'd think that the game would give you the option to spawn right there or somewhere else. Like, there was a game that used to do that. I can't think of what game it was. Like, you could respawn, like, near where you died, or you could respawn, like, way the hell away from it, kind of, like, right. At a base or something.
Well, and my options were, like, either just keep respawning, start a one-on-one deathmatch with a pistol. That'd be sweet.
Yeah.
Or I can enable passive mode. So I'm like, oh, well, maybe that means, like, I'm not on the radar or whatever. So I'm like, put on passive mode.
Yeah.
And all that is you can't be aggressive.
Oh.
So I spawn near the guy, and he runs me over of his car, and I'm like, okay. And then he runs me over again, and I die, and it just says, oh, that guy paid your hospital bill.
Okay. That's,
and then I just he killed me like probably 10 times in a row. And I'm like, I finally managed to get enough time to get on my phone to launch a mission, you know?
Yeah.
So I could vanish out of there.
Wow.
Yeah, it was pretty fucking annoying.
Yeah, because realistically, that's spawn killing.
Yeah, that's
you know,
all he was doing.
It really kind of is. So you would think that they would have, like I said, something in there where you could opt to, you know, just if nothing else, spawn in a random other spot.
Yeah.
You know, like most games would do after dying, you know, at least, you know, a couple of times in the same spot.
But, I mean, you know, if I would have had some sort of decent amount of weaponry, like I was bringing a pistol to an assault rifle fight, basically, you know?
Yeah. What happened to your musket?
You know what? I didn't think about that.
Oh, okay. I was like,
I probably had musket ammo.
I was going to say, oh, that's right. You said you were out of a lot of your ammo. Okay.
Yeah. But I don't use the musket very often unless it's for comedic purposes. Oh. And I probably did have musket ammo and it does so much damage. I might've killed him.
Right.
I didn't think about the musket. Damn it.
Fair enough. All right. So here's, speaking of, this is going to be the only thing I'm going to talk about with games. This is really has little to do with games. So, you know, I've told you before that since being on Effexor for my anxiety and depression, that
yeah.
I...
Which, that sounds like an awesome Decepticon.
Doesn't it? Yeah. Effexor.
Effexor.
It does, actually.
It's like a DJ board.
Right.
It's a new sound wave.
I like it. It's pretty good, actually. It's not bad. Actually, well, now it would just be an iPod and a laptop.
That's true.
Cool. Anyway, so I have this dream. Like, I have these really like odd dreams since being on this, and you know they're pretty common, you know, for the course with this drug. And
right.
I had one last night that I was in this like huge like clan war in Halo, and it was basically like the best of the best. Like these two guys like just argued online about whose clan or whatever was better. So the one dude recruited, like, the highest-end people in the, like, world, basically, to play on his team versus this other guy who had, like, just his friends that were good and everything. Somehow okay. I'm involved in this game, and I'm neither...
I gotta stop you real quick.
First of all, I'm not a Halo player.
Exactly. That's what yeah. makes me laugh, is your dream about this, and you're not a Halo
right.
guy.
I am awful at Halo, aside from shotguns and guarding a base. That's all well, and tank firing. That's it.
Yeah,
other
true.
Than that, I'm useless in the game. So,
distraction.
Yeah, I do that pretty well. I get, you know, I
quick
used to
run around that side of the tree.
Yeah, just running down the middle of the course, flailing my arms around until I get shot. So yeah, so I'm in this game, and I have no idea how because, first of all, you wouldn't want me in your team if you're playing a best of the best game, unless you just wanted, you know. Someone to sabotage you, or there was a shotgun element in the game, then maybe you might want me. I don't know.
I just want to have you're the best around playing right now.
Right? So, this goes on, and the one team, the best in the world ones, they're just mollywopping the other team, just destroying. And apparently it was like a Survivor kind of game. You know, when you die, you're out, you know?
Right.
So it was one of those, and the team's just getting crushed. There's these huge fucking tanks that are showing up, just dropping just all these guys that are level. In the game, I kept seeing like level like 79 or something, which Halo doesn't even have that. I don't believe. Do they?
They do now. Okay, in Halo 4, you can level up.
I haven't played Halo 4, so. Yeah.
It's pretty sick.
Again, not a Halo player, so. Anywho, so these guys are, you know, level 79 or whatever, and apparently that's amazing. And they just keep dropping out of this tank, you know. And other people are blowing vehicles up, and we keep teleporting away, you know, just before we completely lose to kind of regroup and everything. Like, our whole team, like, teleports to another area. Again, this is not really a Halo thing. I don't know how this happened. This is, I'm giving you a glimpse at Halo, Brian.
Halo, Brian Evolve.
Yeah, so, and it gets down to where it's basically like, there's like five guys left. You know, I'm dead at this point, so I'm just watching because I want to see.
Damn it. I was hoping it was going to be like five guys and you in the base shotgun.
Let's go. No. No, unfortunately, this is not the home team.
I got two frags and eight rounds of shotgun blasts.
Bring it
on.
Who
wants some?
No. I don't even know how I died. I just all of a sudden was just watching. So this happened, and basically the guy who's the leader of the best in the world team or whatever is just like, you know, he's like, you know, you barely got away from us this last time. You know, that's not going to happen again. You know, we're going to end you at this point. Right as they are coming through the, like, teleport thing and their massive, like, transporter and tanks and everything, the one guy's like, I got one last thing up my sleeve. And he calls, and I shit you not, Danzig, like, the band, comes in to join the team. So it's their guys and then, like, the other five guys. And all of a sudden, the table just flips over. And these 9 or 10 guys just ruin the whole, like, all these best in the world guys.
When you got Danzig on your side, was he in his mesh shirt?
Of course.
Nice.
Yeah, he wasn't rocking his Misfits look, but he was going with his Danzig look. I have no idea why, out of all the bands that it could have been, it was Danzig, but Danzig came in.
Because metal.
Yeah, so metal saved the day, apparently.
As it always does.
And the underdogs. You know, one. So, I figure I should probably get an adaptation of this together and get this to Hollywood, because...
Right? Or at least send the red versus blue.
Right. And because I think The Rock could star in this.
Oh, yeah. As Danzig?
No.
Oh.
No.
As you?
No. Fuck no. I'm starring as me. So okay, that I can perfect. Run down the middle of the field.
I just figured it'd be funny to have Dwayne The Rock Johnson. And everyone would be like, oh my God, you see this Halo movie rocks in? And they watch it, he dies in like the first 10 minutes or whatever.
Yeah. I didn't die that soon. I lasted about halfway through.
Well, whatever. But you know what I'm saying.
Yeah. No, no. Come on, man. I'll outlive. As long as I don't have to run out in the open, I'll outlive a lot of people.
Because, that's true.
Because I don't tend to just run.
Yeah.
I'm sneaky.
You hunker down.
Yeah, I'm sneaky.
Sneaky.
Yeah. I like your idea, though, because then we'll just turn the narrative of the whole movie. You know, in a world where Dwayne The Rock Johnson is this schlub.
Spartan 2349.
Yeah. All he has is a shotgun, some grenades, and a lot of chutzpah.
A shotgun, some frags, and his genetically engineered balls.
Oh, man. So, yeah, that's the kind of shit that I dream up.
That actually sounds pretty awesome.
Yeah, that was one of the better ones. It was one that I was kind of woke up from, and I was like, that was actually, you know, that was kind of cool. It was like dreaming an action movie.
Yeah.
You know?
See, it made me, actually, this whole thing made me think of something I saw earlier. Was it's a tweet or something I saw on Reddit, maybe, I don't know. But, like, when it talks about how people think, you know, a group of people think when you die, you just go to wherever you dream, mm-hmm. right? And my first thought was like, well, that sucks because I never remember my dreams.
You go to a void.
Yeah, sweet. It's a black void.
Yay.
Where I'm sleepy.
Do you go to my head? Oh, say a trombone again.
Wah, wah.
Yeah.
So, yeah, so if that's true, you'd be going to some awesome places.
Right? Yeah. Well, at least if it's like this one. I mean, even if I die halfway through, you know, at least
it's true.
I'm sure I'm taking somebody with me.
Hell yeah.
With my surprise grenades and such.
Surprise grenades, yep. Like, what's that clinking noise? Oh, God, Frag.
Yep.
Oh, God, buckshot to the ribs.
I can't run away because he keeps buckshotting me, slowing me up. Oh, man.
So, I guess since we're on the subject of games and such, this kind of segues into it. This week, right, I'm listening to podcasts and stuff. And like I said, I've been attempting to do my best to, do more Twittering because I'm back in the upcycle of Twitter.
Right.
Eventually, it'll turn around and I'll be off for like 2 months.
Like tomorrow, yeah.
Yeah, probably.
Tomorrow, you're I'm off the grid and go through the whole Ron Swanson off the grid thing.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Exactly. But so I was in right in between podcasts, and I got followed by this a podcast on Twitter. So I'm like, I'll just follow back because it's a fellow podcast, whatever. Maybe they'll, retweet us or something, right?
Right.
And then they're like, hey, thanks for following. You should listen to our episodes. And I was like, you know what? I'm not listening to anything right now. So I sent them a thing like, recommend me an episode. So they did, and I listened to it. It wasn't bad. They've only like six episodes in.
Right.
It's the Geeky Gamer Girls podcast.
Mm-hmm.
But here's what I want to talk about. Well, I'll give them their Twitter handle. It's at G3P_Cogstop. Cog, like, Cogs and Gears of War Cogs.
Right.
Okay. But what I want to talk about is because they had, there's two hosts. It's Amanda and Catherine. And I'm looking at their thing because I can't remember their names.
Right, and I'm sure you're looking at their things.
If they're listening to this, because they said they're going to check out our podcast.
Nice.
They're talking about playing Magic the Gathering, how one of them just recently started playing, and she likes playing the cards themselves. No, it wasn't the two hosts. It was a guest they had on.
Oh, okay.
That was playing Magic. But one of the hosts used to play too, right?
Uh-huh.
And all I could think was, how terrified our people at the shop would be. Not terrified. Terrified is the wrong word.
Yeah.
Distracted to have multiple girls in there playing cards back when we owned the shop.
Yeah, because it was pretty rare.
It was very rare.
Occasionally there'd be a girl. It was pretty rare, though. Yeah.
Yes.
Actually, that's not right. I thought you were going to go all the way back to Collector's World when that one girl came in and just mollywopped everybody in the shop.
Yeah. Came in and smoked everybody. Yeah. And she walked in and was like, oh.
Yeah.
Boobs.
Yeah, yeah. And then she's like, stomp, stomp, stomp.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, because
I... Comes in like Ronda Rousey.
Seriously. Because I had to play her twice because I played her in the top four as well as the initial rounds. And she curb stomped me both times.
Yeah, I just had to bring that. I told him, give him a shout out because I was like, your guys' Magic the Gathering talk just brought up something I wanted to talk about on my show.
Yeah.
So I'll give you a shout out.
Yeah.
Fair enough. Check the girls out. They're only six episodes in. So.
Yeah. All right. Yeah, we'll have to put their handle on the, what do you call it, in the links and everything for the show.
Yeah, give them a little plug hole this week.
Sweetly.
Yeah. Yeah, I was like, oh, wow, Magic the Gathering talk. Not what I was expecting to hear.
Right. Well, that's good, though, right?
Yeah, exactly. Well, in the episode they had me listen to, it was called My Vagina Has Teeth.
Hmm.
I was like, that's all right. I figured they were talking about the movie Teeth.
Yeah.
They just glanced on the movie, and it went off in a whole different land.
That's fair.
Yeah. I was like, all right, fair enough.
Yeah, that's, yeah. Let me ask you one question.
Yes.
Did at any point the topic of putting like those terrible vampire teeth in a vagina come up?
No.
Damn it. All right.
Well, that's I brought up because I chatted with him for a little bit on Twitter earlier in the week. Because I was like, the things I brought up was like, I'm very disappointed there was no Sarlacc pit jokes in your episode.
Correct.
And they seemed to have no idea what I was talking about, so they must be youngins. And then I was like, is there also a market in the rap community for grills for said vagina teeth?
Oh, that would be tremendous.
Because why not?
That would be great. Well, once again, a new product from Tony Co.
Yes, the Tony Co. Vagina Grill.
I don't know. That sounds like something kind of different. That sounds like something you're cooking meat with.
I'd say it sounds like a place to make tasty vittles.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
The Vagina Grill.
Sounds like something that podcast will be promoting before long. You know, after the man grant. The Vagina Grill.
New from Tony Co. to Vagina Grill. Open up these lips to Flavor Town.
Nice.
Oh, my.
Oh, wow. Lips to Flavor Town, huh?
Lips to Flavor Town.
That might be the show title.
Why is the... Okay. I have Twitter pulled up here.
Yeah.
You know how it just randomly refreshes and it shows you the trending stuff?
Yes.
The very top trending is just the unicorns.
Okay.
What is... what? Why?
Wow.
Why?
Got me.
Oh, it's a band. Okay.
Oh.
Yeah. Don't care.
Nope. See, if we...
moving on. I'm too old for the unicorns.
If you want to talk about Lady Rainicorn or something. No. Anyway. So, how about the water situation where we live?
Yeah, pretty fucked up. I saw it online when I first woke up this morning, and I was just like, eh, I got Collingwood and well water, whatever. I'm not affected by it at all.
Right.
Well, made for some good tweets, but...
You know, I posted one. Yeah, you had some strong ones. It was so weird because, well, to let everyone know what happened, the level of algae in the water in Ohio around the Toledo, Michigan border is at like 2.5 times the normal level. So basically, there's this green sludge on top of the water that's just this algae.
Did you see the pictures?
Yeah. And then there's the ones from space. Did you see that one?
No.
You can see the algae from space.
Oh, that's cool. I'm looking right now.
My sister showed it to me earlier. So anyway, so our city basically, or anyone who gets their water from Toledo, was told that for a while we weren't supposed to bathe, ingest the water. You're not supposed to use it for pretty much anything. Like you couldn't even boil it. Yeah, because it won't kill the toxins in it. And, you know, which led...
holy shit, look at that.
Which led a lot of people to kind of like, how does this just come out of nowhere? Which apparently this has been going on for a while, but it's only recently that they test for this stuff or whatever, I don't know. So basically, the city of Toledo, as of like 4 this morning, had like 0 bottled water. Because everyone panicked and was buying every bit of water.
I saw some report that they're selling cases of water for like $12 to $15, and
people are being assholes to one another about it. You know, like people who have, you know, lying about having babies so that they can get water from other people, and you know, all this. And you know, first I'm sitting here going, okay, first of all, the main thing you need water for is drinking. You know, that's it. But there's plenty
drinking. That's what I got right here.
Calm down. Yeah, there's plenty of other things to drink. So we're okay there. Let's move on to step 2, washing. Okay, well, you know, there's all sorts of, you know, baby wipes and clean wipes and hand sanitizers and all this kind of stuff.
I figure live like Game of Thrones for a while.
Or that, you know, there's leave-in shampoos. There's, you know what I mean? There's all these ways we can just, like, calm the fuck down. We're going to be okay, you know. And yet, and because this is like, it affected, they said, roughly 400,000 people. Which is a lot of people, but there's billions in the country, you know?
Yeah.
So I think we're okay, you know? And, like, all these people, like, buying all this water and freaking out about it. And I'm like, yeah, because, you know, these stores are not going to get more water in when a lot, you know.
Yeah, exactly.
Come on. Like, I saw earlier Kroger, the grocery store chain Kroger, said they shipped like 1.25 million bottles of water out today to the Toledo area. I think we're going to be okay. That's only one company. That's not Walmart, Meijer, Target, dollar stores, you know, any other grocery stores. It's like people just need to calm the fuck down.
Agreed.
It's like, Jesus Christ. I mean,
calm your tits down.
Yeah, it's like it'd be different if this was a countrywide issue. You know, like if all the water in the country was sludge-erific, okay, we got an issue now, you know.
Yeah, exactly.
It's like, you know. On the other hand, it was nice to hear people freaking out about something other than Ebola for, you know, a day.
I'm just hoping it's fixed by Monday because I don't have to deal with any nonsense when I'm back at work.
Yeah, I don't think it's going to be. I think they said it's going to take at least a week.
Oh, no shit.
Like, the, you know, there'll be water available, but we won't be able to really, like, you know, they lifted it to where they said that adults can bathe and wash their hands, but they're still not to ingest the water.
Right.
Apparently it causes, was it like flu-like symptoms, like nausea, diarrhea, vomiting, stuff like that.
Perfect. Sounds like a few days off.
All right. Yeah. Just what you want to be doing on days off.
Yeah, it's true.
Filling trash bags with your waste.
Yes. Perfect. Sounds like a weight loss plan.
Right? Hmm. Yeah. Oh. Terrible idea.
See, here's a secret, Brian. We need to bottle as much of shit up and sell it as diet drink later.
Yes. We'll put it on the shelf next to muscle piss.
Yeah. What do we call it? Algeloss or something?
Yes. That's perfect. Algeloss.
Need to shed 5 extra pounds in a hurry.
It's going to have like a, just this like green like layer on the top of it.
It's going to look like kombucha. You got to kind of, yeah. We don't want to shake kombucha because it's carbonated, but it's going to have like shit floating in it, you know?
Yeah, and this probably won't be carbonated. I mean, it could be, you know,
could be
if we wanted it to be.
I mean, hell, it could ferment it, maybe.
Yeah. I like this idea.
Algeloss the beer.
Yeah. Algehol.
Perfect. Now we're talking.
The first alcohol from algae water.
Algehol. God. That just got to taste like hot shit. Yeah.
If not before, it will after.
It's very true.
Oof. Yeah, you're right, though, with all those cleanse diets and stuff, though.
Yeah, for sure, right?
We should be able to sell this. You're right. I like this idea. I'm gonna go bottle it all up now. Oh, man. Yeah. So that's good times here in the Ohio area.
Yeah, everyone's panicking because of water. Meanwhile, you go to, like, you know, like India. You see all the drinking water is shit.
Yeah, I was going to say, they're pretty much drinking out of toilets.
Yeah, I've seen the pictures of those rivers and whatnot that they're happily bathing in. There's, like, bodies floating next to them.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, there's...
Oh, my.
Yeah, indeed. Yeah, where the water in these other countries is like brown.
Yeah, exactly.
Ours is a little green and we're freaking out. It's like, listen, if this was March, we'd all be like, sweet, St. Paddy's Day.
Awesome.
Ugh. Yeah. What we really don't realize is that it's just Spunk from Swamp Thing.
Aw.
Yeah, he's just
backed up.
Dumping copious loads in there.
Swamp Thing dumping loads. Yeah. It's a horrible image.
Yep.
Oh, good God.
Well, what are you going to do, you know?
Not swim at Mommy Bay, that's for sure.
Well, that's where I first heard about this. Like, 2 days ago, they had a thing on the news around here to not swim, you know, if you're, like, for little kids or elderly or people with immune system issues. To stay out of the water because of this. And I'm like, all right. And then, like, last night, they're like, oh, by the way.
Yeah, hey, don't drink it.
Maybe don't drink it.
Don't splash in your eyes. Nothing.
Right? Well, that's what I thought was funny today when they were like, it's okay to wash your hands with. And I'm like, but people touch their face, like, thousands of times a day.
Yeah.
Doesn't that seem like at some point you might, like, oh, I have something in my teeth. You know.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hey, I'm trying to stay thin. You know. What
exactly.
Yeah.
Algeloss.
From Totico. The company that brought you muscle piss. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. It's pretty wild, but, you know, we'll get over it.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, way worse could happen.
Oh, yeah.
For sure.
Yeah. I'm just glad that I didn't have to deal with people acting like savages over it. So hopefully in a couple days it'll calm itself down. I think as of like just a couple hours ago, there's been things all over Facebook and whatnot that like stores have tons of water now.
Yeah, well, yeah, because I mean...
Yeah, well, like up here, you know, like this isn't a nationwide chain, but they're in six or seven states, whatever, Meijer, you know, they're going to pull water from their other stores probably and from their warehouse, all of which are within, I mean, within a couple hours, we have tons of Meijer stores that they pulling onto a truck and then running the truck down here and have a shit. Same with Kroger. There's tons of Kroger around, you know.
Yeah, it's not that huge of a deal. Yeah,
Walmart pretty much has, like, rolling warehouses that are going around, you know, so it's, I'm sure, you know, I was like, yeah, just give it a day and it'll probably be fine. And sure enough.
Exactly. I mean, I imagine you guys are on city water, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so you guys are just buying bottled shit or whatever.
Yeah. Well, they pretty much already do here, so.
Yeah, you know, I mean, because we got, you know... We got the well water for washing and stuff. We don't drink it because it doesn't taste that great. But we have like 10 gallons of Collingwood water.
Right.
I think we'll be fine.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Well, that's why I said it's like, for, you know, for most of the time, it's like, eh, I can drink pop or I can drink something else in the meantime if I need to get by. So, that, you know, we're not drinking all the water we have in case we need it. But whatever. I've dealt with my water being turned off because they were working on pipes for like 3 days. If I can deal with that, I can deal with this, you know?
Right. Well, it's like I ordered pizza for dinner because, you know, extra children in the house makes it way easier on me.
That's what I had.
And I hopped online to order because fuck talking to people.
Right.
And on Vito's website, it was like, we brought in water to blah, 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 blah. No worries, Toledo.
There were a lot of places closed down because of it. A lot of restaurants had to shut them down.
A lot of coffee shops I like because I follow them on various social medias were shut down.
Yeah, lots of restaurants.
Except for one. One that they just opened up downtown, Bleak House. Mm. They're like, hey, we make our pour-over coffees with bottled water, so come on in.
Ah, nice.
And we sell ice cream. Tap water free.
That's smart, though. I mean, you know, because the way people were freaking out about it, you know. And there were, like, Burger Bar and stuff were shut down today because... of it, you know, a lot of restaurants had to shut down.
Yeah.
So
what are you gonna do?
Well, yeah, I mean, just health codes. You can't, you know. I mean, it's like, hey, it's a little algae. It's like you said, you know, it's like for all the stuff we dump into our bodies. I think it seems like we should be able to deal with this.
I can perfectly understand elderly, or if you got an immune problem, or little kids.
Oh yeah, sure.
Yeah, but like
us.
I'm sure I'd be fine. I might feel like a little like ugh, but. Yeah. I'm sure I've drank way worse.
My first reaction was, I have IBS. So it's a normal day, right?
Yeah, like, oh, regular water, gotcha.
Yeah. I will say this, though. I mean, nobody wants me vomiting, because that's not fun for anyone around. Not the way I project.
Wait, GoPro video.
Oh, that's a horrible idea. Oh. Sound like I'm Ken or Ryu from Street Fighter about to say Hadouken, just like really amping it up.
It's like the super ultra combo Hadouken.
Yeah. Or, you know, the way, the best way I think I've heard the way I vomit described is really from Ferris Bueller. Because it really sounds a lot like that. Ugh, crazy. All right, well, enough of that. So what else we got?
Local nonsense.
Here? What else we got here?
I'm looking.
All right, well, while you're doing whatever, I'll just mention. I posted, because I thought that I've been dealing with some, feel like my depression's really kind of amped up over the last few months with various upheaval and stuff in my life. And I wrote a short blog about it that I've been posting links to on my Twitter. And also, but I posted it today. I don't know why I didn't do this before. I posted it today over on saltylanguage.com on the blog page, of course.
Naturally.
You know, as a new Napalm the Earth. So but that's about my depression. If anyone wants to check that out, that's on, again, saltylanguage.com and then the blog link. Or you can, if you follow us on Twitter, I posted the link on there as well.
I would have to say, too, when you're done reading it, shop on Amazon.com through the banner at the top of the page.
Right, because nothing cures depression like some good retail
like
therapy.
Like some impulse buying.
Right. Nothing will help my depression more than buying things.
Perfect.
Yeah, you can buy all sorts of books about depression and other things.
Exactly.
You know, it's funny,
though. Or like jerk-off toys, if that helps you out.
There you go, right?
Have at it.
Or you can just buy me lots of, you know, lots of fun things and send them to me, or just not.
Or not.
Yeah. But, yeah, yeah. You know, it's interesting because I thought that I was kind of dealing with that more and more, and it's like, you know, I actually, it kind of hit me today as I was taking my medicines that I'm on probably 5 medications that all have drowsiness as a side effect. And I'm
Why
like,
aren't you not sleeping more?
Well, no, that's my point is I actually, like, once I'm kind of sleeping, I could just sleep all day.
Oh,
and not,
I see.
Not get out of bed. Like, I can wake up and be like, eh, and turn over and go right back to sleep.
Right.
You know, it takes me a while to go to sleep, but once I'm asleep, it's just like, man, I could probably just lay in bed all day. And I'm not sure that that's depression as much as it's just being lethargic from the medicine.
Sounds lovely, though. Yeah. That's why I wanted to do that today.
Yeah, I did,
just lay in bed, but
right.
Somebody had to get up and go to work.
Fair enough. But, yeah, you know, it's... So, you know, I figure it's time to go see the doctor, and either way I need to straighten it out, you know.
Yeah, fair enough.
Because if it's depression, then I need to tweak my medicine on that. If it's the other, to where it's just a bunch of medicines making me drowsy, then maybe it's time to tweak, you know, some of those so that I'm not lethargic all the time.
Or throw some meth into the mix.
Yes.
A nice little pick-me-up.
That was option 3. You just didn't let me get to it.
Do a couple knuckle bumps.
Yeah, because meth is always option 3.
Option 3, yeah. Mm-hmm. Plan 3, meth.
I like it.
That's on every plan I write out.
Right. Every day on my to-do list, I always make a number 3 and then write meth.
Now, Mr. High, we're going over your business plan. What is this number 3, meth?
You're like, well, step 1, steal underpants. Step 2, step 3, meth. Step 4, profit.
Yeah.
It's pretty self-explanatory.
I mean, yeah.
Have you not seen South Park and Breaking Bad?
Just saved on my desktop business plan.
Yeah. All it has is just step 3, though.
It's a flow chart.
Yeah. Tony's printing up flyers for AA. Step 3 is meth.
Meth.
They're like, we're not sure about this. I'm like, hey, listen, you'll get off the booze real quick.
Like, no, I'm serious. They show up to a meeting, Method Man's there.
Yeah.
Oh!
All right. He's like, hey, guys, you shouldn't drink anymore. Here, try all this marijuana. All the weeds.
All the weeds.
Oh, damn it.
Oh, shit.
All right, then.
Speaking of lethargic, whoo!
Yep.
Sorry, that yawn catch out to me for some reason. Same I don't know why, because I haven't had coffee in like 8 hours. Damn
hell?
It.
How'd that happen?
I don't know. Usually I always have, you know. Lately, this week, I've always seemed to have one in my hand for all the time for some reason.
Don't you have concubines that bring you coffee on demand?
That's a great idea.
I know.
I was trying to mash up coffee and concubine.
You don't need to. You can just mash it up when they bring it to you.
That's true. Just like if it's not hot enough, throw it in your face.
Of course. As is tradition.
Like Mugatu. Yeah. Throw it to latte.
Yeah. Exactly. That seems fair. Yeah.
I really need to go as Mugatu for Halloween.
You really do. Yeah.
With the Mugatu collar.
Well, of course. Yeah, you can't. You can't do it any other way.
It's true.
I like this idea a lot.
I just need someone to be my Derek Zoolander.
Yeah. Mm. You need Jeremy to do that.
That would be pretty funny.
Yeah, because you need somebody. It's just I'm not right for it. Jeremy would be perfect for it. I think he can give Blue Steel better than I can.
Blue Steel. You can be David Duchovny's character. We'll have your hand in a big glass thing.
Nice. Damn it! How come I'm always the guy with the hand in the glass? Why do I gotta be Mr. Pink? Yeah, so you got any other random shenanigans before we get to things?
Yeah, just a couple odd things that, you know, as my brain works, as I'm working, I always jot stuff down that I think of and such.
Yeah.
I made this delivery for my job to like a main bank building downtown, right?
Uh-huh.
And I take it up to the top floor where the executive offices are at.
And just dump it off the top.
It would have been awesome because there's a big opening all the way down to the bottom. That would have been great.
Yeah.
No. But
you look down and it's like vertigo, though, right?
That'd be cool.
The stairway? No. Oh.
All right. So I go to, because I know where the people are because I've been there a couple times before, but they're the only, these, like, woman and the guy are the only people that I think are on this whole floor. And this building has all these offices, all these big executive meeting rooms with all this mahogany furniture and all these nice couches.
Right.
And all I can just think about is, like, the evil shenanigans that go on up there. Like, guys in, like, deer masks getting blown on the couch or something, you know? Something horrible.
It's like a cross between, like, Caligula and True Detective or something.
Yeah, yeah, something. Ah. Exactly.
I am the Yellow King. Blow me.
I mean, there's just all this, like, nice-looking, old-looking furniture. It's just like, you know, there's some heinous shit that's gone on in some of these rooms.
It's really just some sort of an Illuminati kind of place.
That's what it feels like. Especially because it seems like they're the only people up there now. Yeah, right.
Maybe they're all that's left.
I don't know. It was weird.
Like, how old are you? 970.
It's like the ancient vampire from Underworld.
Yeah. All right, then.
It's just weird. I don't know. That's all I could think about when I was up there, looking around at all this furniture and no one was around.
Well, here's what you do. What you do next time. Crossbow with wooden stakes in it.
Maybe.
And just see what's going on, you know?
I kind of thought about, because, like, where the freight elevator is, mm-hmm. right next to it's, like, a big room where I had a bunch of couches, and I kind of thought about nosing around.
Yeah.
But I'm like, it's a bank building. There's probably cameras everywhere.
Probably, yeah.
And they don't want to be like, what's that bearded security guy, or what's that bearded delivery guy doing?
Especially from a distance, they'll be like, what's that terrorist doing?
Yeah, exactly.
Uh-oh. Next thing you know, it's...
Durka, Durka, Durka.
Oh, no. Tony's in trouble.
Oh, my God. I have...
I know, right?
Damn it.
A Team America, but with us, would be fantastic.
No, I have a song that I meant to show you such a long time ago.
Oh.
And we're not in the same room, so I can't really play it for you.
Oh, all right. All right.
But you know the song, it's a... not a great rap song, but it's the "Don't Drop That Dun Dun Dun."
Yeah.
You heard that?
Yes.
Right. Some guy remixed it with "Don't Drop That Dirk Dirk."
Oh no!
And it's a bunch of Indian guys doing it.
Wow!
Don't drop the Dirk Dirk. Don't drop the Dirk Dirk.
No, it's a bunch of Indian guys singing it.
Yes.
Okay. Or rapping, whichever.
In fact,
rhyming, freestyle.
I'm writing this down. It'll be it'll be with our. Our Piggy Juggalo video.
Naturally. That everyone must see. I'm sure you probably already have, but, you know.
Yeah, if you watch it at midnight, or if you're on the internet.
Yeah.
I'm sure you've seen the enormous Juggalo getting a lap dance on his gut. on his hanger of a gut.
It's not even a lap, though.
I know. And he's, like, bobbing his head like he's enjoying it.
Well,
I don't know.
Maybe his erogenous zone is his belly button range. I don't know.
I was thinking maybe the pressure of her ass on his upper gut was rubbing against his inner gut, which was pushing on his lower gut into his nuts or something.
Right.
I don't know.
That's probably what's going on, yeah.
It was horrible.
It was, yeah.
I saw that. I'm like, how is that man living?
How was that man, like, getting out of the house is what I was thinking.
That's true.
Because, I mean, you know, good on him for, you know, getting out and doing some, you know, doing some sitting.
I guess.
Looks like a large man. I don't know how big he is, but he looks like a giant man.
He was enormous.
Yeah.
He is not running with an axe or a hatchet or whatever. He's slowly lumbering.
Oh, I was thinking he's on his,
hover round. Probably with an ice cream scoop.
I was thinking he's going around on his hover round.
With a hatchet?
Yeah.
That would be awesome.
Right?
All right. I could see that.
Yeah.
And I always say whenever I see nonsense like that, and I always want to be like, if I could... go to the gathering of the Juggalos, but not participate, like be invisible.
Mm-hmm.
I would want to go just to see dumb shit like that.
Yeah.
But at the same time, I want nothing to do with it.
Right.
You know?
Yeah.
I'm sure it'd be quite the experience.
We just, you know, we just need to get the money and we'll just send our man Butter with a GoPro. He could be our man on the street.
Not a bad idea. Mm-hmm. Although, I don't know, he'll probably trade it for, you know, bitches. I don't know, Juggalo shit.
Bitches.
Fago.
Bitches.
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 No.
I wonder how many bitches you could get for a GoPro.
I don't know.
Juggalettes, they're... that is.
If it's Juggalettes, probably about 303. If my, my trade rate is right.
Your arithmetic has not been strong today. So,
that's very true.
You know.
Yeah, we covered it earlier.
Yeah, we may have to bring John in to help us out. Official Salty Language accountant.
Yes.
Slash math teacher.
Slash math teacher.
Slash math teacher, yeah. I don't want to downgrade him or upgrade him. I don't know, John, which, if you listen to this, I don't know which that would be. I'll let you tell us. Or
I
not.
I would hope an upgrade to be our accountant, because there's very little work to be done.
That's true. Well, it also pays nothing. So
also true.
Yeah, so it's pretty much like the job he already has.
Perfect.
I kid.
Winning.
I kid.
Another thing I was thinking about, Brian,
mm-hmm.
was, you know how you go to, like, on vacation or whatever, and you go to some, I don't know, Borneo or some shit jungle, and they let you zip line through the rainforest?
Yeah, I do this all the time.
Right? Mm-hmm. Exactly.
I just did. Actually, I wasn't even moving last week. That's what I was doing. I was zip lining all fucking day.
Zip lining through the jungles?
Yeah, all day. I was like Batman going through a city.
Now, I'm thinking, this is, you're on the right track here.
All
right. I'm thinking, how cool would it be to take, like, I don't know, $100, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you buy some enormous warehouse in Detroit.
Okay.
And then you zip line through it. You set up like zip lines and shit through it.
This would be pretty, yeah. All right, I'm in. I
like
this.
Like through old factories and stuff?
That would be pretty cool.
That'd be cool.
It would be. Especially if you could fight villains along the way.
Even better. Like, oh, zip lining with like a paintball gun?
Yeah, why not? I was thinking, like, can I throw a villain into a vat of something? Like, you know.
It's Detroit. Anything's possible.
Yeah. Well, I'm sure there's vats of various things in Detroit up there, you know, to throw people in. And the $100 will probably cover all that.
Oh, definitely.
I would think. I like this idea.
I mean, $100, you know, you can take two of those dollars and you got yourself four bags of little chips. That's four homeless guys ready for to be shot at or thrown into vats.
Well, I'm not necessarily going to throw homeless people into vats of things.
It's Detroit. That's all they have.
It's not entirely true.
All right. Okay. There's that one family.
Yeah. Right. Oh man. Oh, you and your blanket statements.
I forgot about Thunderdome.
Yeah. Yeah. See, that's what I'm afraid of. Is in order for this to happen, we may end up getting, you know, overtaken by, you know, various Mad Max people.
Well. These are risks you have to take.
I think at that point you're just like, look, you can have the building.
Yeah, it's all yours. Yeah.
Here, you can have the zip lines too. We don't.
Hey, I already
set
up the zip lines.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. I mean, I'm just saying. If there were money up here, I'd say you could charge for it. But good luck.
Okay, good luck. Yeah, good luck to you, sir.
Maybe you can trade. Someone can trade a yak for it or something.
Nice, the old city yak.
Yeah, because you know Detroit is rich with yaks.
Well, I hear, you know, wildlife is encroaching since everyone's leaving.
Yeah.
There may be a yak somewhere.
Maybe.
I think they're getting, like, bears and shit into the outskirts.
Well, it makes sense, yeah. You know, as we push into, you know, nature and such, you know, animals are going to, they need somewhere to go. So Detroit it is.
Detroit it is.
Let's just hope they don't get in the way of the, you know, Superman Batman movie.
Is that where it's filming?
Yeah.
Oh, perfect. Yeah, plenty of shit to knock over.
Right? Well, they actually showed a thing on the Detroit News yesterday that was a helicopter shot of, and they were like, oh, we're bringing you a sneak peek of the Batman-Superman movie. And all it is, they're just showing you debris. Like, they're just like, here's something after a scene was filmed. It's just a bunch of shit blown up. And they're like, we can't tell you what buildings were involved because it might give away the plot lines. And I'm like...
Or it looks like the rest of Detroit.
Yeah. I was like, not to mention, this is really not a sneak peek. For all I know, that was just a shot from Detroit.
Yeah, it's true.
You know, I don't see Batman or Superman, you know, zip lining through a building or anything. So
no.
Now I will say they may have already beat you to your idea.
You're probably right
because you know,
those sons of bitches.
Yeah, Affleck's zip lining around there, taunting you because he's Ben Affleck in a bat suit zip lining around Detroit.
Although, as much as we're shitting on Detroit right now, Fall Beer Fest is in Detroit,
right?
Although it's in the same, like, within a few blocks of, like, Comerica and Ford Field and all that.
Well, of course it is. Yeah. Because otherwise people would be frightened, probably.
Yeah. I hate the shit on Detroit, too, because there is a ton of, like, good food and stuff up there.
There is a lot of good things in Detroit.
It's just falling apart.
Detroit really is a tale of two cities, you know, within itself.
Yeah.
You know, there's parts of it that are fantastic, and then there's parts of it that are like, nope, you know.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
You have, like, amazing food and all these awesome, well, not awesome sports teams, but
you got the
professional teams. You got the Wings.
Yeah, the Tigers and the Wings are
pretty good teams. Wings, yeah.
We won't talk about the Lions just yet. And, you know, the Pistons stink right now, but, you know.
There you go.
You have Michigan State, Michigan, you know, athletics right around that area. I mean, they're not Detroit, but they're pretty close, you know.
But, yeah, then you go a little too far out, and it becomes the Wire in a hurry.
Yeah, yeah, because before long, you're like, oh, this is 8 Mile. Uh-oh.
Yeah.
Like last night, again, on the Detroit News, one of the first stories, they're like, blah, 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 blah. And then the first picture they show is a street marker that says 8 Mile Road. And I'm like, oh, boy. Sure enough.
Oh, shit.
Someone got shot.
Boo got shot?
Yep. No. Maybe. Oh. It's like, I've been up in that area. I got looked at. Like, I didn't belong up there.
Oh, you didn't, I guess.
No, I didn't.
Like, I rolled over, rolled on one. Sir, where's M&M's house at? Yeah.
It's like, nope. Can you tell me how to write back the way you came? All right, come on. Yeah, it was pretty rough when I was up there the last time. So,
I got one more little bit of randomness.
Yes.
I just listened to the latest Nerdist podcast, right?
Uh-huh.
Which is live from Comic-Con.
Right.
And their guest was CM Punk.
Right. Okay? Did you see any of the stuff he did for them?
Some of the video. I heard about the videos, but I haven't seen them.
He did a pretty good job of being a correspondent.
But what I got to ask, because, you know, you watch wrestling more than I do.
Yeah.
Is all that shit about him leaving was legit. That wasn't a work.
As far as anybody can tell, he is totally done with wrestling.
Because that's what it sounded like during the podcast. Because everything, all the lead up, I was like, ah, this is all work.
Yeah.
You know, I'm walking, all that.
Yeah. From what I understand, he was really unhappy with the creative direction of his character. And basically was like, fuck you, I'm out of here. Even though that he's still under contract, which means they'll get him for breach of contract. He'll have to give a bunch of money back. And he won't make any of that merchandising money, you know, during this time.
Right.
You know, and but from everything I've read, I guess he's a guy who is pretty good with his money and has made a good amount and is just like, nah, I'm done. Between that and, you know, being beaten up, basically, you know, for how many ever years he's, you know, been on the circuit.
Yeah. I think he said his first professional match was like 97 or something.
Yeah.
So that's a long time to be getting the shit kicked out of you for other people's pleasure.
Right, and again, this is a guy who started in ECW and stuff, you know, so he's a guy who's, you know, gone through some pretty, you know, brutal shit, you know, not like the WWE guys where most of them are just doing the pro wrestling thing. He was, you know, getting hit with kendo sticks and chairs and, you know.
Right, yeah, all that good stuff.
Yeah, which I'm sure takes its toll.
I had no idea. I had to ask because I figured you'd know more than I did.
Yeah, it's a shame because he's a really entertaining guy. I'd like to see him do something like a podcast or something because he's so damn entertaining.
Yeah, he told a great story about him running his first marathon. The story's called Mile 18. You should listen to the Nerdist podcast.
Okay.
Yeah,
I will because he's a guy. Like I said, I find him pretty entertaining anyway. So
yeah, it was pretty good. It was good.
He's a big comic nerd and stuff, too. That's why there was a lot made when he showed up on The Talking Dead the one night.
Right.
After The Walking Dead, because they were, you know, all the wrestling news sites and stuff were basically like, nothing was said about, you know, him coming back or all this. And I'm like, I don't know why people can't understand that he's just done.
Yeah, like, yeah, that's a wrap, y'all.
If he just wants to be done, he could just be done and walk away. I mean, again, he's a guy who could find work doing something else.
You know, right.
He really could. Because, you know, I'm sure through the Nerdist and stuff, they could probably set him up with some work somewhere.
Well, they talked about on the podcast how they want to have him reprise Rowdy Piper's role in remake They Live.
That'd be great.
That would be great.
He can come be our third mic.
There you go.
You know, I mean, I'd be okay with that. Or he can do it from Chicago, wherever he's at, you know. We'll work through Perfect. Skype. It's fine.
We can go Chicago. I love that city.
Yeah, that's all right, too. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I ain't removing Chicago. Thumbs up.
All right. Yeah, I'm in. I don't care. I like Chicago. I'm in.
Perfect.
Nice. All right. Damn it, I don't want to be a Cubs fan, though. Or a White Sox fan. All right.
You have to be a beer fan.
Oh, okay.
That just, you and I will just hang out in Pippins every day and just drink. Yes. All right.
Except for when we're podcasting, because CM Punk's straight edge. So
he doesn't have to drink with us. He can have a soda.
All right. Fair enough. I don't think he does that either, but all right.
Well, he have a water or whatever, whatever those pussy straight edge people
a
drink.
Mineral water. Oh, dude. Way to go after our new co-host. Jerk.
You know.
You don't mind if we change the podcast to a one where we talk about pro wrestling and stuff, do you?
If for some reason in the infinite universes.
In the absolutely zero chance we land him.
Slow down. In the infinite amounts of universes, right. In the one universe where CM Punk becomes our third mic.
Yes.
We would change the name to the podcast to CM Punk and Friends.
Yeah, that's probably true. That's true. I think that would definitely get us more listeners rather than Salty Language with CM Punk. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, you're probably right. Damn. All right, I'm okay with this.
Or probably just Punk and Friends.
Yeah. I don't know. That sounds like something that has to do with, like, you know, pumpkins.
That's true.
Pumpkin Friends.
It's like some awful kids show. Yeah, pumpkin Friends. They're all, like, living in a pumpkin patch, dreading October.
Stop it. Yeah.
That's when the people come and take some of us away.
Oh, God. It'll be like that. The one Simpsons Halloween special where like they're waiting for Milhouse is waiting for like the great pumpkin basically. And the pumpkin comes to life and just starts murdering kids.
Nice.
Because you know, they're like, I forgot who it is. It's like carving a pumpkin and he's just like, you know, and then he sees like a white pumpkin and he all of a sudden he's like a pumpkin racist towards the white pumpkin.
Pumpkin
yeah,
racist.
It's pretty good. Yeah.
I've never seen
I
that one.
I can't remember which season it is. It's one of my favorite ones. Because obviously the whole, you know, that whole story one spoofs the Peanuts one.
Right.
So yeah, that's, yeah. All right, so we got a to-do list then. We got to somehow get CM Punk to agree to allow us to move to Chicago and be on his podcast.
Yes.
That doesn't exist.
Right.
Yet.
Yeah. Like, well, the offer is we have a podcast. But if you want to be a third mic, we'll change the name to this.
Right. I like that.
Yeah.
How could he say no?
Exactly. Well, on one stipulation, he's got to cut it out, that whole straight edge bullshit.
I don't think that's going to happen. That's kind of been his thing.
Oh, okay.
All right. I can live with it. We'll make up for him. Well,
fair enough.
I guess we'll have to start doing drugs.
What are you going to do with Chicago? Yeah. It's the Chicago way. The Untouchables, right?
Probably not.
No? Okay.
No. That's all right. We'll figure it out. I like this idea, though.
It's true.
Yeah, I don't think it's going to happen, though.
They bring a bat, you bring a knife. They bring a knife, you bring a gun. It's the Chicago way.
Yeah.
I think that's the quote.
I just start with a gun. I don't even waste my time with the other stuff.
That's true. A good gun, like a Tommy gun.
Right. And like, oh, we're going to have a knife fight Friday. And you're just like, I have a gun. So,
like, I'll be right there. Yeah,
so
I
win,
knife.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah. And it's like, I have a fucking rifle with a bayonet. I brought a knife.
There's a knife there.
I'll stab you
in the
It's
like one of those
you.
Goofy Final Fantasy knife guns.
Yeah. Oh, jeez. Yeah. That'll teach them.
Yes.
Like, see, this is... it's the only knife I had.
Yeah. My bad, it's got a revolver in it.
Oops. Or better yet, you bring him one of those like chainsaw guns from, was that Gears or whatever?
Ah, nice. Yeah. The, God damn it, I can't remember any of it.
I'm terrible with that stuff.
Yeah, I'm drawing a complete blank.
Yeah.
I'm not braining real well again.
Yeah, that'll happen. Yeah. I figure it's just because I'm out of practice on the podcast. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah. All right, well, you got any other random shenanigans, or should we get into fangs?
We can get into fangs.
All right. You want to go first? Do you want me to? I got like 15 things here, so.
I got two.
All right.
So why don't you go first? All right.
So the first one I read. I lost it already. Son of a bitch. There it is. Kind of going back to the San Diego thing. Did you see the story about Adrian Curry chasing down the dude who, like, groped her friend and, like, hitting him with her? She was cosplaying as Adrian Curry was cosplaying as Catwoman, like, from the Batman animated series.
Right.
Her friend was Tigra.
Okay. You know,
Tigra wears basically a black bikini, and that's pretty much it. Well, some dude tried to stick his hand down, like, the bathing suit or whatever of her friend. So she chased him, and let's see, where's it at? Where's it? She chased after him, knocked him down, and hit him across the face with the butt of her whip.
Wow.
Yeah. So I guess, you know, the guy got away or whatever, but it's still. I just love the fact that she just was like, nope. Because this is really kind of becoming a problem. I don't know if you heard about the underage girl that got assaulted.
No, I didn't hear that.
Yeah, I don't know if that is, like, it's not, I don't think it has anything to do with cosplay, but there was like a 17-year-old girl that got I think sexually assaulted and was basically found just like on the floor, you know.
On the floor?
Yeah, just like somebody just beat shit out of her and left her kind of a thing. And
wow, that's awesome. Jesus Christ.
The last I read about that is that her traveling companion had been questioned and gave like two different stories. So he's, you know, he probably had something to do with it. So, yeah. But there's been a lot of this with, like, you know, women dressing up all sexy like for these cosplays and guys for some reason thinking that it's okay to grope them or whatever. I don't understand this.
That's the nerd hormones taking over.
Yeah, but I mean, it's not, but you know, because this shit happens in other places as well, you know.
Yeah, fair enough.
But yeah, it's one of those things that, you know, there's a thing going around that I've seen plenty of times. It's basically like cosplay is not consent. You know, just because a girl dresses sexy, and this is the same way as life. Just because a woman dresses sexy does not give someone permission to, you know, openly.
Tigra is asking for it.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So I just love the fact that Adrian Curry was just like, fuck you, and chases a guy down and beat his ass.
That is pretty funny.
Yeah.
She actually, I'm looking at a couple pictures. She makes a very good animated series Catwoman.
Yeah, she really does. Like, she does this every year. She, like, was it last year or the year before? I can't remember what she went as, like Slave Leia or something else, and she had to go change her outfit because they were like, yeah, you're too sexy. So, and she was pissed about it because she was like, you know, it's authentic, basically, and they were like, we don't care. It's
Yeah, like, that's terrific.
Yeah. But, yeah, she does this every year where she cosplays when she goes to San Diego Comic-Con and stuff, you know.
Right.
And she had some of her friends with her this time, and, you know, unfortunately some asshole tried to get a little diddle on while...
Get a little molesty?
Yeah. Idiot.
Yeah, that's a problem.
No. Hope it was worth it so he'd get socked across the face.
That is awesome that someone punched him across the face.
Right.
Or she did, I should say.
Yeah, because, you know, that's... I like that, because, you know, this shit shouldn't be happening, so I have no issues with him, you know, getting punched in the face.
He should
have gotten worse, but because, like I said, I don't think they caught the guy. So, you know, there's a lot of talk going on right now about whether or not they should be posting harassment guidelines at the conventions. And it's like,
might not be a bad idea.
Right? But it's like, the only harassment guideline they should have to put up is don't be a dick.
It's true.
You know? I mean,
just to have, and this is how to get to the Comic-Con crowd. You just got to have Will Wheaton's picture with Don't Be a Dick, since that's like his thing.
Yeah, exactly. You know? Yep.
Yeah.
It's like, this isn't difficult. You know, you know where that you are. You know, do you have permission to just openly grope people? I mean, there's very few places, I should say, that you have open, you know.
There's a time and a place.
Yeah. It's pretty rare, though, you know.
Yeah.
So, and at San Diego Comic-Con, definitely not one of them.
Now, what if you cosplay as Sir Gropes a Lot?
No.
Damn it.
I'm not going to okay you going to San Diego Comic-Con.
All right, I'm going to return my costume.
What costume?
Hilarious.
Nude. Well, what? I'm swinging Dick Man.
What?
So, yeah, that's, yeah. All right. So, want me to do another one, or you want to go here?
I'll go.
All right.
This one's out of my range a little.
Okay.
Because it talks about basketball.
Okay.
But I had to pull the story just for the, yeah, you'll understand.
Okay.
Phoenix Suns player, Brian, P.J. Tucker, I'm sure you heard about this, arrested on suspicion of quote-unquote super extreme DUI.
Oh, right. Okay, yeah.
That's the only reason I pulled this was because of the
super extreme. Sounds like something that was on Nickelodeon
DUI.
In the 90s. That would have been a great show.
Super extreme DUI?
Yeah. Right? Seems like something...
Good
Yeah, it should
Seems
be
like an awful reality show.
Right, I was going to say it should be on like True TV.
Yeah, for sure. So your police saw him, you know, reported seeing him driving his Mercedes extremely slow through a stop sign.
Like actually through the stop sign or
well,
just...
Like just he just
oh,
ran.
Okay. Would have been better
so
if he just drove over the stop sign.
See here. He had thick and slurred speech, watery, bloodshot eyes, according to the report. Mm-hmm. Detected a quote unquote powerful alcohol odor as he interviewed him. During the walk and turn, Tucker stumbled to the sign, caught himself on a construction fence.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So far, sounds sober.
Sober, right?
Mm-hmm.
I'm trying to find his blood alcohol. Ah, here you go. His blood alcohol content was 0.222. It's pretty high.
Yeah.
So super extreme DUI is 0.20 or better.
So it's like the morbidly obese of DUIs.
Yes.
Okay.
Is super extreme DUI.
Super extreme.
So what I'm saying is, Brian, when are we having super extreme night?
October, what was the date of beer fest?
Oh, it was 28th. Oof.
I kind of want to get a breathalyzer and see where we are when we're at different parties and start writing down how drunk we get.
I've always thought about that, too.
Mm-hmm.
I bet you we can get that on Amazon.
Oh, that's a good idea, yeah. Because then we can, you know, just keep track of it and be like, this was our drunkest party ever.
Yes.
Although,
this was the super extreme night.
Super extreme night. Oh, man. Yikes.
Problems?
Yeah.
Saw the eyebrow.
Having some issues here.
No.
Super extreme DUI.
Super extreme DUI. In fact, there it is. Hashtag for the t-shirt. Super extreme, slightly intoxicated.
Yes. Hashtag SESI.
SESI.
You know, super extreme, super intoxicated. Or... My
I kind of like super extreme, super intoxicated.
that is ridiculous. That's a pretty high level of alcohol.
Yeah. 0.222. It's pretty good. You have a panther behind
yeah,
you.
Yeah, my cat's making all sorts of noises. Apparently she's looking for her last night on Earth.
Sounds very familiar.
It happens, you know. I'm going to give her some Algenos, or what was that, Algelos or whatever it was?
Algelos.
Yeah.
Drink up, kitty.
Yeah.
No, you don't want kitty shit everywhere.
Not at my house, no.
Yeah.
I'm going to start carrying a bottle with me and going to other people's houses, though. Oh.
It's like a kind of smart bomb.
Uh-huh. Yeah, I'll be putting it in smart water bottles.
Putting that to smart bomb, perfect.
Yep. Like, here, make your baby formula with this.
Enjoy. Twist your mustache and run away.
Well, of course, as is tradition.
Of course.
So the next one I have here is going back to the wrestling, which was former WWE champ Daniel Bryan catches suspected burglar. Him and his wife came home, and there was somebody at their home, like, trying to, you know, break in or whatever. And he subdued the guy, like, chased the guy down and subdued one of the two until the police right. got there.
So I hope he just came in with, like, a suplex or something.
No, it says in there, like, his finishing move is the, you know, the no lock or whatever. But, you know, they were like, he didn't apply that. And I was like, damn it. I wanted this to be, like, the John Jones story. Remember when right. he fucking, what was it, he like armbarred the guy or whatever until the cops showed up? Like, that's how you do, you know. Like, if you're going to put a guy down, you do that, and then you go defend your title that night, you know.
Isn't that guy kind of like a little fella for
he
a wrestler?
Is. Yeah. He,
you
yeah.
imagine.
Go ahead.
I'll say, imagine if someone was caught breaking into some, like, fucking monster's house. Like, I don't know. I can't
like
think of
like a guy like the Undertaker size or something.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Just some big beast that, like, benches 400 pounds or something.
Big Show.
Yeah.
Big Show just hits him with one of those chest slaps that every time he does it to a guy, I'm just like, I bet that guy's chest is red for a month, you know?
Oh, it's got to suck.
Oh, it's got to hurt so bad. I mean, his hand is just probably the size of most guys' chest, you know?
Yeah.
Oh. Whereas Daniel Bryan's like 5'8 or something like that, you know? He's like you say, he's a little fella.
So, for a wrestler.
Yeah. But still, he's pretty good, though, because he's nursing a, you know, he just had neck surgery not that long ago.
Oh, you definitely don't want to throw a guy in a suplex then.
Probably not. Oh. Yeah, probably not worth
it. As funny as it would be.
Yeah. Yeah, it was funny. Daniel Bryan said, unfortunately, the guy wasn't in very good shape, so it didn't take much to chase him down.
Oh, fair enough.
Yeah.
That's what he needs. Someone to, you know, like Taz to come home, the human suplex yeah, machine. Right? And just suplex him through the backyard until the cops come.
He's just fucking Taz-plexing him everywhere. The cops show up and they're like, what number are you on? He's like, I don't fucking know. I lost
all these little dents in the yard, yeah, a big hole in the fence.
At that point, he's just got him in a Taz mission, you know. Just because he's tired from fucking suplexing him around.
Hell of a core workout.
Right, yeah. All of a sudden, Taz is, like, ripped. Like, wow, man, I've never seen you in better shape. He's like, yeah, right?
Yeah, oof. See what happens?
Yeah.
It's the catch a burglar workout.
Yeah. Which, oddly enough, endorses Algeloss as the fat-burning content.
Perfect.
Yeah. Don't change your diet. Just drink Algeloss.
Oh. Algeloss.
Gross. Ugh. All right, what else you got?
This is another one that just caught my eye. I saved this on my phone with the link. That just the title I left was "Piggy Wanted a Donut."
Okay.
Because this is in Monroe, Connecticut. A 4-year-old kid was banned from a donut shop, right?
Mm-hmm.
Because. I'll just read the story. Curious kid has been banned from Monroe County Donut Shop because he asked another customer whether she was pregnant. She was not. She was just in the donut shop. Now, mind you, this kid's 4.
Right.
Right.
So the kid's not going to really,
he doesn't know any better. Yeah. So 4-year-old Justin's mother, Rebecca, said she was mortified at his question and apologized immediately. Her response was, oh my goodness, I'm so embarrassed, I'm so sorry. The woman took it all in stride and accepted the apology, but the managers of the Donut Inn don't forgive so easily. When they showed up the next morning, how often do you get fucking donuts at this place? They told the little boy he wasn't welcome.
Are you talking about the non-pregnant woman or the other one?
The other one. They said the next morning. Oh. It's like, really? Yeah. So they walked in. The owner said that they weren't welcome there. And they're like, she's like, she said he's not allowed in here. I looked around and I said, him? Point at her son. She said, yeah, he's rude.
Well, in fairness, the other woman's probably one of their better customers.
That's very true. You know, good call.
I'm just saying.
I just, you know.
Not that I'm one to talk. I, you know, if I had my way, I'd probably be eating donuts every day.
Donuts are fucking delicious.
And in my head right now, peaches is going through my head as I said that. By
millions of peaches?
Yeah. Cause
peaches for me?
Yeah, because when I was like, if I had my way, I'd eat donuts every day.
Oh, nice. Know, I was thinking, you know, Ryan Bryan DeWitt, you ever heard of donut peaches?
No.
They kind of look like a donut.
Oh, okay.
They're delicious, but they're actual peach. Anywho. Yeah, I just, you know, I thought this was just funny that there's some heifer in there trying to get a donut. Some kid called her fat, basically.
Wow.
And then the owner's like, hey, your little kid that does any better, he's out.
Yeah, well.
For life.
Donut in doesn't screw around, man. That's, you know, the if you're rude.
Donut in does not screw around.
Not for him. It's donut out. This kid, kid's going to come in the next day with like a mustache on to get donuts. Meh. Yeah. I need a donut, see?
Or, you know, he's like 16, he's going to stroll in there like falling down. And just
yeah, right.
Slap a submachine gun on the counter.
Right. Oh, shit.
You remember 12 years ago?
I am. He, like, he pointed a picture of him on the wall. I am that boy. You created me. I am the villain.
I was going to do it. Yep.
Say, I am the villain that this donut shop deserves. I wasn't going to do Batman voice, but whatever.
That's perfect.
Yeah. There we go. All right. So we're ready to do a show now. We're back in sync here.
Oh, boy. That was scary.
Yeah. We'll do that.
Yeah, for sure.
Stupid. I can't believe they banned a kid for that, though. I mean, you
especially
know.
A four-year-old.
Yeah, it's like, you know, the kid just needs to have it explained to him that, you know, you only, you know, you don't say that kind of thing until they leave.
He's only a few years out from not shitting his pants.
Right.
I mean, let's be honest.
Maybe. We don't know. He may still shit his pants. The real question is, I want to know if the owners of the place or if the mom have a Twitter account, because I want to read around that time if they did.
Oh, that would be awesome.
Because I want to see if anyone posted anything about it.
Right.
You know. Probably not.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Yeah.
I mean, it is Monroe, Connecticut. I don't think they have the internet there.
Monroe, Connecticut?
No.
Yeah.
It's a one donut shop town.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Hopefully. Wait, I don't know.
I don't know why. I was where I started Googling Monroe, Connecticut. What am I doing?
Yeah, no, that's one of those things that's not worth your time.
No, it really isn't.
Sorry to the people of Monroe, Connecticut.
You're out.
You're out.
Half our listenership, sir. We didn't know it.
Yeah, right? Oh, no.
Shit. You know those downloads we just got?
Yes.
All from Monroe, Connecticut.
They're out. Damn it, we have to give refunds on those.
Because they just discovered the internet.
Oh, man. What, did Al Gore just do a tour through there or something?
Yeah. Yeah, like AOL like crate dropped a bunch of discs.
Nice.
So they just discovered the internet. And in those crates were a bunch of, like, Zunes, so they could listen to us.
Nice. I like that you went Zunes. I was going to say Newtons, but all right, Zune's a better one. Because most people are like, Newton, what the hell is that?
Yeah, what?
Man.
That's right, Steve, if you still listen to our podcast. You and your Zune.
Yep. So, I saw this story on Huffington Post.
All right.
The headline for it says, sex toy stuck in woman's vagina for 10 years.
10 years.
10 years.
Worst part is she's only 12.
Yeah. A 38-year-old woman in Scotland who told doctors she was suffering from shaking.
Whoops.
Come on, man.
I dropped my sex toy. Sorry.
It finally came out after 10 years.
Finally came out. I was scared.
She told doctors she was suffering from shaking, incontinence, and severe weight loss. Turned out to have a sex toy stuck inside her vagina that had been there for 10 years.
I lost my shillelagh.
Oh, no. Hate mail can be sent to Tony at Monotony on Twitter.
Please.
Please.
I like interaction.
Yeah, true enough. The woman who the article notes was of normal intelligence. Did they give her an IQ test? I mean, you know, like, okay, hold on.
That's translation. She's not retarded.
Right? Maybe. We don't know. Well, this says she's not. So, told doctor she used the 5-inch toy in a drunken sexual encounter a decade ago and didn't remember whether she took it out or not. How do you not check? All right.
Hold on.
Okay.
Jeannie, can I ask you a vagina question?
It's for science.
Okay, Brian's reading a story about a Scottish woman, right, Brian?
Yes.
That for 10 years had a 5-inch sex toy in her vagina, and she couldn't remember if she removed it. And it recently came out.
Well, they took it out.
They took it out forcibly. Is that something you would probably notice?
Forcibly.
Yeah, okay. So it's weird.
Okay, so forcibly makes it sound a little different than it was. It's not like they fucking hit her with a hammer until it came out.
What? Okay. I just picture him hooking up to like a tow truck and just dragging her behind the truck until it popped out like a cork.
They just use like Jaws of Life to get it out.
The Jaws of Life.
Okay. Ugh. By the time the surgeons found it, the toy's effects were potentially life-threatening. It had caused a bladder blockage that was forcing urine to back up into her kidneys and also created a vesicovaginal fistula, which is a tract that causes urine to flow into the vagina.
They should have just left it all there and let her just like go walk in the woods.
See if the wolves find you?
Yeah, exactly.
Wow. And real quick in the comments, people are just like making all sorts of comments about like, you know, I don't think normal intelligence is what, you know, quite the same thing here.
How did she install this?
Yeah.
Was she like loading a blunderbuss and had the little ramrod thing and just, it's not too deep now. Oh, well.
Maybe. Yeah. Well,
it'll come out eventually like a splinter.
Well, a few people in here ask a very good question. Like, clearly she doesn't go for regular checkups.
Very true.
Oof.
10 years. That's insanity.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, it doesn't sound like a lot of fun. Or maybe it was. I don't know. Like, I just don't understand how you can have something in you like that for 10 years and not be sure.
Yeah, I don't.
Like, it's crazy. Just...
Go ahead.
No, when they get to the point of removals, she's like, oh, yeah, that's from that drunken encounter or whatever. I don't remember if I took it out. Like, how do you remember that, but you don't remember at some point, you know, maybe I have something weird stuck in my vagina?
And clearly, she's not getting much action.
I wouldn't think.
You would think, unless she's dating micropenis dudes.
Well, I was
going to
say, maybe she's got this thing buried deep. You know, I don't know.
Ah, that's bizarre.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, then. Do you have any more?
No, I'm just blown away by that last one.
Well, excellent, because I've got some great stuff here.
Yeah, bring it on.
All right. Furniture designed to look and feel like human skin.
Was this like in the late 30s,
no.
Germany? Or?
No, nothing like that.
Oh.
This is not from the Wild Bill collection or anything either. You know.
Oh, all right, fair enough.
UK artist Gigi Barker has created a line of furniture made to look, feel, and smell like human skin. There is, as New York Magazine reports, quote, a chair meant to mimic a squishy roll of fat and footstools that resemble deformed testes.
What the fuck is wrong with people?
Okay, so here's... Oh, there's a little more here. Okay.
You like my balls, Ottoman?
It's
a little Ottoman you put your balls
on. Right. No, go ahead. Rest your feet on my foot scrote. Ugh. The furniture's been infused with human pheromones and aftershave.
Oh, so it's male.
Barker tells Wired that some of her art's most enthusiastic fans are youngsters. Quote, children have been one of the most interesting demographics in relation to the work. Without any of the hang-ups we later developed, they are free to truly explore and interact with the work. Work regarding the human body is very personal, and we all have a very immediate reaction to it, so reactions have reflected this. So
when's Lazy Boy going to carry this stuff?
Yeah, right? Yeah. The deformed testicle footstools cost about $775. The skin chair will run you about $2,550, as in $2,550.
Can I get non-deformed testicle footstool?
I don't see any options at this point.
Well, that's just horrible.
Mm-hmm. Now, can you get a smaller one that's just like one testicle? Or
the Lance Armstrong model?
Yeah. Oh, why would I?
Yeah, I mean, if I'm going to have a giant pair of balls in my living room, I want them to at least look nice.
That's the quote of the show right there.
You know what I'm saying?
Right. I just, you know, like, for decorating purposes, do you just, like, drape a kilt over them or, you know?
And then the fact that she's like, kids are the best part. You imagine some kid just tackling your balls ottoman.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's like, oh, that's just weird.
I love the way this smells. Like, oh, no.
Like, oh, God.
Yeah.
Like, oh, Dad, did you spill Funyuns on the ottoman?
Every father's nightmare, their daughter gets out there and he's like,
like just no. Nose
just hugging him.
It.
Yeah. Just, no.
What are you doing?
Oh, man. Yeah, this is. Yeah.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
That's bizarre.
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to the vagina easy chair, though.
You can really fall right into it.
Exactly.
Oh, man. Cat goes to lay in it and just disappears.
Just vanishes. Because, of course, the cat's going after, you know, fish.
Right. Oh, my. Oh, that'd be horrible if that's what they scented it with. I mean, geez.
Well, I mean, if it's all natural, right?
Well, I know, but, I mean, you know, like this one, there's aftershave being used, so why couldn't they use, oh, I can't remember the name of it now.
Summer's Eve?
No. What is it? Last Podcaster Standing did a commercial for them. Like, there's a fragrance, Vulva, that's what it was.
Oh, perfect.
Yeah, so they could just use that instead of aftershave, or maybe there's aftershave for, you know, the whole nethers that, you know, they can use.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Or, yeah, I'm sure there's different options. You know, you have the vulva or whatever. Yeah. Or you just have, like, after gym stank.
Right. Oh. That's what I was wondering about with these is on a hot day.
I prefer my ottoman in the hot day scent.
Yeah, do they waft a bit? And, you know, it's like, ooh. Like, can you get swamp stool? Well, that sounds really awful.
Swamp stool.
That sounded way worse than what I was even going for.
Like, you got your feet kicked up on it, and you gotta, like, just peel your calf off it.
Yeah, but see, when you think of stool in a different context, now it sounds now it sounds like what may form, like, in the taint region.
Yes, yeah. Definitely.
Oh, enough of that. All right, let's move on to anything else.
Please. Oh, my God. Let's get out of there.
I'm gonna dry heave now. Did you see the controversy with OkCupid?
No.
No? They ran apparently they ran an experiment on their website without telling people.
So they did like Facebook did?
Kind of, yeah.
Yeah, all right.
OkCupid's disclosure that the popular dating website intentionally misled couples about their suitability could open up a U.S. FTC inquiry. I'm trying to skip to. Where is it? They wanted to see whether its assessment of their matchability led to successful dating. Quote, to test this, we took pairs of bad matches and told them they were exceptionally good for each other. When we tell people they're a good match, they act as if they are, even when they should be wrong for each other. OkCupid's actions, at least four legal experts said, appear to be in violation of a provision in the FTC Act that prohibits unfair and deceptive practices by a company that result in misleading or harming customers.
Wow, that's interesting.
Yeah. So basically they took people who were, you know, bad matches and told them they were great, and people who were great matches and told them they were bad to just see how it would turn out. And
right.
From, I'm just trying to skim this here. If I believe right, like the ones where they were like, oh yeah, uh-oh, damn it. The ones where they told people, oh yeah, you're a great match. They tended to turn out as like they got along. It's the placebo.
Yeah, this website tells us we're meant to be each other together, so let's be together.
Exactly. So it clearly, you know, they're showing the placebo effect or the, you know, that it's psychosomatic to some extent.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah. There's more to this than that, but they were, you know.
It's the old, we've already been approved, so.
Yeah.
Thing. Yeah.
Yep. I just thought it was funny because it's like, you know, to me, basically what that tells you is that it's, you know, the whole dating thing and whatever is, you know, keep your mind open, I guess.
Yeah, I guess, exactly.
I don't know what else. I thought it was kind of funny because I dig experiments like this. I just like seeing how humans behave, you know, with stuff like that.
I hear you.
And honestly, even if I was a member of their site at the time they did this, I would have probably been like, okay.
Yeah. Like, that's cool.
Yeah.
You wouldn't have got all bent out of shape?
No.
How dare you? Yeah.
Well, it depends. If I'm wearing my top hat and everything, I may have been chaffed a bit. But
that's true. Well, especially if you're wearing your top hat and, you know, spectacles and all that, and they right. match you with some commoner.
And if they happen to catch me with my fighting trousers on.
Oh, shit, then, it's on then.
Then fisticuffs would have been had, good sir.
You would have.
Indeed.
Not only fighting trousers, but your commoner stomping boots.
Correct.
And correct.
I'm grabbing my lapel again.
It's perfect.
Even though I don't have a lapel.
Yes. They didn't have to know that. Damn it.
I mean, I'm grabbing my lapel that I clearly have.
Yes.
Yeah.
Nice lapel grab, right?
Thank you.
Yes.
I am known for my lapel grab.
Signature move.
Right. Right. In all the, you know, wrestling games ever, that was my finisher. The
lapel grab. Lapel grab.
Like, okay, now what?
No, what it is, the lapel grab is, Brian, is the choke hold. Mm-hmm. You put the choke on when you grab your lapel.
Oh, I see. So it's for, I get you. Okay.
First leverage, right. So you can, like, really sink the triangle
okay,
in.
I get you. Then, right? Yeah, okay, all right.
Yeah.
What if they don't have a lapel, though?
No, you grab your own.
Oh, all right. Yeah. Right, because I always have a lapel on.
It's like a gi choke, you know, in jiu-jitsu.
Okay. Yeah. All right. I'm back in. Okay.
But you're using your own lapel as opposed to theirs.
That's fair.
Yeah.
I actually don't think you're allowed to use your own gi for leverage. I think that's a rule.
I know you can use sleeves and stuff like that. At least you used to be able to.
I don't know.
All right. Maybe not in UFC, but in just like regular.
Just in jiu-jitsu.
Jiu-jitsu, yeah.
All right. We'll see. I don't
know. Not that you ever see guys in UFC wear gis anymore.
I was like, I don't even know anybody that
it's all anymore. Ball huggers anymore.
Seriously.
Or board shorts.
Yeah. I prefer the board shorts because I really don't need to see scrote when I'm watching UFC. You dig?
Mm. Word.
Mm. So, yeah, I thought the OkCupid thing was interesting. Boy, there were a lot of people really with chapped asses about it, though.
Oh, I imagine. Oh, you're playing with our emotions.
Well, you know, I mean, I get that. But on the other hand, it is a free site.
Yeah.
I don't know. Maybe they have an upgrade. They probably have some sort of upgrade option, you know, like most.
I would chalk it up to go fuck yourself.
Yeah.
If I was OkCupid.
Yeah.
Here's our press statement. Tap, 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 tap. Well, go fuck yourself.
Yeah.
That is all.
I don't know, man. It's just like the whole, like, we're going to give you all this test or all these questions, and then we're going to match you up with people with, like, whatever. It's like, okay, just because somebody likes comic books doesn't mean that I'm going to get along with them, you know? Even if we have 10 things in common, like, we could, like, art, comic books, the same music, blah, it doesn't mean we're necessarily going to be, you know, that we're going to get along. What if we, you know, what if they're, you know, we both are into graphic design, but one of us happens to be a modernist and the other's a postmodernist? I mean, the fights you could have, you know?
All right, so I'll play the girl. We're matched up for, because we like comic books, right?
This is making dreams come true all across the internet.
I know. So, all right, so we're matched up, right?
Yeah.
Because we like comic books.
Yeah.
We're at some romantic dinner.
Right. You love Rob
Liefeld. Oh, my God. Have you seen Rob Liefeld's art? It's amazing.
And oddly enough, I immediately become a murderer.
See, it doesn't work.
No. No. And there's differences, too. You know, I mean, even within the stuff, you know, like saying you like comics is different than love in comics, you know, and liking comics is, you know, there's different types of comics to like. And
yeah, exactly.
You know, just like movies. Like, oh, I love movies. And it's like, oh, me too. And it's like, what do you like? It's like, oh, I like movies like Transformers and things where I don't have to think ever.
Yeah.
And then I'm going to
have explosions.
Yeah. And then I'm going to go, listen, if we can't watch The Notebook and Snuggle, I just can't do this.
I can't have it.
I can't have it. That's what's in my dating profile, you know.
The Notebook and Snuggles.
Right. And Long Walks on the Beach, of course.
You should make a profile with that just Jesus. Has like every category has something that contradicts something else within that category.
That's a good idea.
Loves The Notebooks and Kung Fu Hustle. Like, what?
What's the problem? I don't. That's called being diverse. I don't. Yeah.
Exactly.
loves The Notebook, and then somewhere else puts hates chick flicks.
Yeah, you know? Hates chick flicks. Exactly.
Oh, crikey.
Drinks responsibly. Loves getting fucked up.
Yeah.
Like, what?
Yeah. Just have all your pictures and be like you just drunk with beers everywhere.
Yes.
Like straight edge.
Like we'll take one of those. I don't know if you saw the picture. Probably not. You probably don't look at it much at a beer fest pictures.
No, not yet.
Okay. Some guy.
Well, none of them have me in them. So.
Oh, fair enough. Some guy took Stroh's boxes.
Uh-huh.
And made himself into a Stroh's Loki, complete with like the big horns and everything.
Nice. All right.
Yeah.
I'll have to look because that's pretty strong.
I'll have to see if I could find it. It was on Instagram from their hashtag.
If he wants to take that next level for next year, is you get a t-shirt made with that on it and wear the t-shirt.
It's true.
Because then, you know, that's meta right there.
And then you go as like.
That's how awesome it was last year that I'm wearing it on a t-shirt this year.
No, but then he goes like Moosehead Thor wearing that t-shirt.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Yeah, like make Mjolnir out of a Moosehead box.
No, I'm thinking if you're going to go, well, never mind. It's not the same thing because Beta Ray Bill's not a moose. So.
Oh. Yeah, he's some weird bird thing, isn't he?
I don't remember what the hell Beta Ray Bill
he's
is.
Some fucked
not
up alien.
Like the worst thing. I don't know. Whatever.
Who cares?
If you're going to go as a different Thor, you have to go as the frog Thor.
Awesome.
Yeah. Although you could just take a baguette and, you know, put a beret on.
And then have Mjolnir. Like, what are you? Frog Thor. Uh-huh.
With your flawless French accent, obviously.
Clearly.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I like this idea.
Just up like a mime of Mjolnir.
Oh, God. There's no mime that's worthy to pick that up. I'm sorry.
That's true.
None. Somehow there would have had to have been some trickery going on there.
Trickery.
Mm-hmm. And clearly, if you're using trickery, you wouldn't be able to pick it up because you have to be, you know, pure of, I forgot the quote, pure of heart and other things. I think it's like gluten-free or something, and that's the only way you can carry it.
Probably.
Yeah. So I got one last story here.
All right.
And this one I thought I brought up because of all my, you know, team no sleepers on Twitter and such. All-nighters may give you false memories.
Like Halo Wars.
Yes. Even though none of it existed in the actual realm of Halo, which is the weirdest part. Not sleeping enough doesn't just hurt your focus and productivity. Turns out it could hurt your memory, too. Sleep-deprived people may think they've witnessed something that never happened. Like, you know, playing Halo well. Because
awesome.
I did live halfway through, and that's probably perfect. Not happening. In case you missed, there's a video. 7 to 8 hours a night is about right for most people. That's overwhelming evidence that the lack of sleep impairs cognitive function, though few have investigated the role of sleep deprivation in the formation of false memories. I really don't want to read all this. There's a lot of technical shit, but...
Blah-de-blah technical.
Toward the bottom it has, we found memory distortion is greater after sleep deprivation, says study co-author Kimberly Fenn from Michigan State. Woo, shout out.
Woo, Spartans.
And people are getting less sleep each night than they ever were because of electronics.
Yeah, fair enough.
I can't sleep. I'll go on Twitter. 6 hours later, oh my God, yeah. I have to get up for work.
Oh, shit. I can't recharge my brain. Let me see what these thousand other people are up to.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, I'm, you know, because definitely one of the things that helps you sleep is, you know, thinking.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Like, I get on Twitter and I start reading stuff and then I start thinking of tweets and various other stuff. And then I, you know, that's just, yeah. Like I said, I posted earlier in the week that I actually have figured out that as a person with depression, that I used to use Twitter as a way of kind of just dumping thoughts out of my head. But the more I think about it, I actually think it's creating a snowball effect that I go right. on there and maybe I'm a little down or whatever, and then I start, and then I just keep going. Like, you know,
oh,
you know what I mean?
'Cause
you, yeah, you post one, and then you think about it, and then you post it, and next thing you know, you're posting like 50 negative thoughts.
Right.
So I've been trying to keep that more over on my blog and then keep Twitter more for Twitter.
Not that.
Shenanigans.
Oh.
Anyway, so back to this. You know, obviously sleep deprivation can have a lot of, you know, bad effects on you. Like,
I'm pretty sure if you lack enough sleep, you just die.
Yeah. Well, yeah. They said that after, I forgot how many hours it is, you become basically drunk with a lack of sleep. I think it's after like 32 hours or something, that basically the way your brain works is the same as being drunk. You know, because
that's fun.
It makes sense. Like,
that'll save me some money.
Right. It's not a path you want to go down, trust me. I've been...
Dude, are you kidding me? You see it happens.
Yeah, I know.
It starts to get to my bedtime, and I'm like, ugh.
Yeah.
Ugh, my reserve power.
Yeah, no doubt. Meanwhile, there's me. It's like, oh, I should go to bed. And it's just like, yeah, I'm not tired. 3 days later, I'm still not tired. God, I want to sleep. That's why, you know, on Twitter when people are, oh, my insomnia, and it's like, listen, unless you can count your insomnia in days, you're not really suffering from insomnia.
Right.
You know, you're just having some issues getting to sleep tonight or whatever.
Yeah, you're just having a bad night.
Yeah. Where is it? Oh, here we go. To gauge the effect of insufficient sleep on memory, friend and colleagues kept college students awake for 24 hours to see how likely they'd mix up event details. They assigned 104 volunteers into one of four groups one evening. Two groups were shown a series of photos depicting a crime being committed, a man stealing a wallet. One of those groups got to go to bed right away, while the other group stayed awake all night in the lab. The remaining two groups did it in reverse. One slept while the other stayed awake, and they all viewed the crime photos in the morning. In the next part, the participants read narratives containing statements that contradicted what the photo showed. A description might, for example, say that the thief put the stolen wallet in his pants pocket, but the photo showed him putting it in his jacket. Students who had been sleep-deprived for the entire experiment, viewing the photos and reading accounts of the crime, were more likely to report those false details from the narrative as though they had happened.
Except for Larry. He kept yelling the black guy because he's a racist.
Right, of course. Yeah.
Damn it, Larry.
You know, I'm curious, though. Well, they said the people got to go to sleep right away. So I guess I was going to say, because it just kind of makes you wonder if you just, you know, because, you know, like the game of telephone, you could have people paying exact attention. But it's like, OK, if I tell you the story, then you tell someone, you know, it gets distorted along the way.
Yeah.
But I thought this was interesting because I could see this. Like, I can really, like, see how this makes a lot of sense.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Yeah, especially if you start to become drunkish.
Mm-hmm.
Clearly your brain's not exactly working as it should.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Well, and remember we talked before on the show about how when you sleep, your body, your brain basically empties the recycle bin and reboots. And
yeah, so if you're it's not like, sleeping,
yeah.
Kicks its feet up, has a red stripe.
Puts its feet up on the old scrote footstool.
Yeah, the old ball stool.
That still sounds horrible.
Yeah, it does sound horrible.
It sounds like your balls are just like leaking.
Like some sort of horrific, some sort of, I'm going to wait for you, all right, horrific Algelos explosion.
A side effect, you mean?
Yes. Figure out a way for you to finish your water.
Thank you. Yeah.
Yeah.
My Algelos.
Your Algelos.
Warning, Algelos may cause explosive diarrhea. By may, we mean definitely will within 5 minutes.
A.K.A. ball stool.
Don't
trademark.
Don't plan on going anywhere. In fact, enjoy Algelos while on the toilet. All right.
Yeah, perfect.
I'm just going to keep tweeting, you know, taking my Algelos. Shit, that should become a hashtag. Just Algelos is like code for, you know, taking a shit.
Taking horrible, horrible shits. Like, horrible time-altering ones.
Right.
Yeah.
Oh, man. So, yeah, there's that. Man. Well, that's the last I got. Well, we've handled quite a bit tonight.
Hell yeah. Because we're goddamn professionals.
Yeah. Well, we had to come back and, you know, put our foot in the ass of, you know, the podcast.
Everything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Come back with a little, this is how we do it.
Exactly.
You know. So, yeah. You got anything else?
Nah, I just got my little assassin co-host over here meowing away trying to get my attention.
Watch out.
Yeah, I know.
Can't be dangerous, yo.
Can't be dangerous.
Mm-hmm. Next thing you know, it'll be like hip-tossing you and, you know, putting a sword to your throat.
Like, well, it does have, you know, a sword on the end of every finger, basically.
Exactly. Like, maybe there is some fight in you.
Yeah.
Damn it, quick
question. I do have to say, because it's been a long time since I've owned a cat, I forget how much fun it is just watching them play with shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, this cat goes bonkers for anything.
Yeah, for like the dumbest stuff.
Yeah, like grabbing a piece of paper in his mouth and throwing it across the room, and it's like, rah, it's all over.
Well, you know, it learned from you.
I guess, yeah.
I hope everyone just pictured you, like, dressed as a cat, throwing a piece of paper across the room.
Well, naturally.
That's
what I do best.
Yeah.
Rare. Yeah, when I was had that gig on Broadway before they shut our show down.
You mean off Broadway?
That too. Yeah. Off.
Awful gig.
It was actually an alley.
Yeah.
I was trying to convince people to come back there.
They're like, is this for a show or kinda? Oh man. Yep.
So I am fresh out of subjects.
Alright. Me too. So I guess we'll just tell people to go to saltylanguage.com. Again, check out my blog under the blog link. Tony will have fun time videos up for you this week.
Boy, will I. Don't drop that Dirk in an awful lap dance.
Yay. And if that's not depressing enough, read my blog. The blog's not that depressing. It's just, you know, I just figure it's been a while since I, you know, since we did, what was that, episode 47 was the episode where we talked about that. That's
that
how
long ago
it's been, yeah.
Yeah.
So, you know.
That's what we like to call Salty Language Year One.
Yeah, yeah. That was a callback there, if you will. So, yeah, if you, speaking of episode 47, while you're on the website, you can check that out along with all the back episodes, since they're not all up on the iTuneses. You can get all our social media links and various other stuff along or on the website. You know, links for the show, and you can find the link to podgodsnetwork.com, the network that we are a part of. Check out all the shows on there and tell them we sent you or something. I don't know. Whatever. You can check
do some.
Yeah. You can check us out on the random replay on cweradio.com. And and of course we don't want to forget that, you know, if you're in the mood for molesting
go to Comic-Con?
No. There's a donate button on the website also that you can molest to your heart's content.
That's true.
100% of the proceeds go right into our pockets. No. Well, that's not true, but PayPal will take a cut.
Goes into the, you know, keeping the podcast running.
Right. Help us a little bit, you know. Not making money on it, just, you know, help pay our costs and so we can keep bringing the free funnies.
Exactly.
Or disturbing.
God damn it.
Whatever it is you get out of our show. All right.
I'm sure people will feel better about themselves as they're listening to our nonsense.
Yeah. I think that's it, right?
That is all.
I can't.
Except for our own shameless plugs.
Oh, right. You are correct.
Yes.
Nice. You can find the show on the Twitter machine at salty_language. You can find me at Stunami.
I am at Monotony, since I'm tweeting again.
Yeah.
And Monotony_, if you want to check out my Instagram.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. For all his new pics.
I'll probably put him on Twitter, too. So, yeah.
Yeah.
Whatever.
Yeah.
Not that anyone does. But hey, we got a voicemail, 415-857-2589.
Mm-hmm.
Call us, you dirty bitches.
Yeah. Call us and tell us your outrage at Tony making whatever statement he made earlier when I said, oh, at his Scottish accent.
Yeah, you know, losing shillelaghs and such.
Right.
Who has a 5-inch shillelagh, honestly?
Not her anymore.
That's true.
Well, unless they gave it back. I don't know. Do you think she asked him to keep it?
Oh.
Can I have that?
It's like a charm necklace.
Right.
An awful, stinky charm necklace.
That's what one of the doctors, instead of having like an ear necklace, he's just got stuff he's pulled out of people.
Out of people.
Yeah. All right, then. So, yeah, on that note.
I'd say on that disgusting note.
I'm going to go vomit.
Yeah, exactly.
So, yeah, have a beer. You'll be fine.
Stay salty.
And don't forget to check out Dirty Halo on the website. Oh, I'm glad I didn't dream of that kind of Halo. Oh.
No. Although that would be some interesting DLC.
Oh, God. All right, then. So, yeah, we'll see you next week or whatever.
All right.
Hello there. Angry Ginger here, host of the 7 Days of Geek podcast. I see you are currently listening to another podcast. How about trying out another? 7 Days of Geek is a weekly comedy pop culture podcast that geeks out about all things cool, like movies, TV shows, comic books, video games, podcasts, and web series. Blah, 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 blah. Of course, this is a show that's loaded with just a little bit more than a dash of humor. Now look, I know the word geek might scare you away, but come on. Don't act like you don't geek out about something. We all do. We are the podcast that asks, what are you geeking out about? Come share your interests with us. You can find us all over the fancy interwebs. Psst, I'm over here. Do me a favor. Do the world a favor and jump on your desktop or finger bang your smartphone on over to 7 Days of Geek. You can find us on iTunes, Stitcher, wherever you listen to podcasts. We are there. Come listen. You can also find all the 7 Days of Geek present shows, along with this one, 7 Days of Geek, at 7daysofgeek.net. That's the number 7daysofgeek.net. Geek out.
You're listening to the Clutch and Wiggle Entertainment Radio Network on CWERadio.com, home to such shows as Aristocrats Radio, Broadcasting Under the Influence, The Courtesy Flush, The Clutch and Wiggle Experience, and my own show, The Radio Ghost. Clutch and Wiggle Entertainment Radio. Uncensored internet talk radio, sports, sex, political and entertainment news. Because what else would an immature adult want to listen to?